barn when these teams meet. Every game played like it's the only one in the season that matters. But a victory this year moves the winner closer to a national championship. The loser waits till next year. And the only certainty is that few players will emerge unscathed. Miami has always been known for a big play offense. But head coach Jimmy Johnson has the defense to carry his team this year. Bobby Bowden runs his squad with characteristic flair and has a high-flying offense to match. Florida's most explosive teams converge to settle a score. Number 3 Miami battles number 4 Florida State today on CBS Sports. The capital of the great state of Florida, and the polls this week will show you the importance of this game. Number 3, the Hurricanes of Miami take on number 4, the Seminoles of Florida State. Without a doubt, this is the game of the week. You know, some 40 years ago, Florida State was a girls' school. Then it became co-ed. In the 50s, they started building Doak Campbell Stadium, held only 9,000 in. This afternoon, we'll have a crowd in excess of 63,000 watching today in a game that will carry ramifications as far as the national championship is concerned. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. I'm Brent Musburger. We're going to be talking throughout the day about the national championship, what this game means. But Coach Bobby Bowden of Florida State says, hold on, everybody. There's something else we got to do before we can even think about a national title.
Our goal with our players has always been to let's try to win a national championship, you know. This is the first year we changed it. Our number one goal, win the state championship. That will get you a shot at the national championship.
Florida State's recognized as being one of the better teams in the country. I think University of Miami is in the same position. A winner of this will go to a new plateau, and I think everybody around the country will say, hey, you know, they are for real.
So you think about this state, Pat Hayden, also the University of Florida at LSU tonight. But let's talk about what this game means as far as the national title is concerned.
Well, Brent, both of these teams are capable of winning a national championship, but I believe you have to get to the Orange Bowl to do so, because that's where either Oklahoma or Nebraska will be probably undefeated. Now, if Miami wins this game, they have the easier remaining schedule. Only Notre Dame, I think, has a chance of beating them. Florida State still has to go to Auburn and to Florida, and that would be much more difficult for them.
Now, Clemson and Notre Dame are both idle today. Clemson players are probably pulling hard for Florida State to win this game because the Seminoles have tough games at Auburn and also Florida. Notre Dame is watching, and they should be saying, go Canes, because they look them straight in the eyeballs in November down in Miami. Now, we're going to check in with Jim Nantz, find out what's going on this busy Saturday, and then we'll come back here to Tallahassee. Jim?
All right, Brent, there is a lot of action to report early, including number 1, Oklahoma, taking on Iowa State. Sooners scoring on their first two possessions, Collins and Stafford getting it into the end zone for Oklahoma, and the Sooners lead it 14-0. Now, here's a surprise. Auburn against North Carolina, 3-3. They've just started the third quarter. Auburn managed only 61 yards total offense in the first half, and they're tied with the Tar Heels right now in the third. Now, Tennessee well in front of California, and a couple of offensive stars today for the Volunteers, namely quarterback Jeff Francis, 14 out of 16 so far in the game, and one touchdown pass. This, the screen pass to Reggie Cobb. Cobb, a freshman, has scored 3 times today, giving him 10 on the season, which is tops in the NCAA, and Tennessee just running away with it there. Another surprise, Texas Tech 10 up on Texas A&M. That is in halftime now in Lubbock. And the Red Raiders get off to a terrific start when the Ice Cube touched the ball for the first time for Texas Tech. Tyrone Thurman, 5'3", 130 yards, and he sails 74 yards and helps ignite the Raiders now to a 10-point lead over A&M. Michigan State at Iowa, Big Ten opener for both teams. Danny McGuire started at quarterback for the Hawkeyes. He has gone the entire way because he's looked good here today. Here's one of the two scores now for McGuire. In fact, it's the go-ahead score at the moment. Danny McGuire to Travis Watkins. It covers 14 yards, and Iowa leads it by 7, just starting the third. And in the Ivy League, Penn over Columbia, 3-0. Now, should the Lions lose today, they would tie the losing streak of Northwestern at 34. A baseball note. This morning in St. Louis, Mets GM Frank Cashin announced that manager Davey Johnson would return to manage the team in 1988. But according to Cashin, Johnson will step down as manager in 1989 and take a front office position at that time. And we have Miami and Florida State coming up, and we'll continue on CBS Sports in just a moment.
If you own a house, you gotta own a shop vac. This baby's got the power to pick up almost anything.
Got broken glass, nails, or wood chips? Shop vac gobbles up stuff that would kill an ordinary vacuum. And a shop vac wet dry can even vacuum water like a flooded basement.
The washing machine is flooding the house.
No.
Every house needs a shop vac. Starting at under $50, a shop vac is heavy duty, not heavy money. And remember, if it doesn't say shop vac, keep shopping.
Fixing this water damage will cost $1,200. Could I have prevented it?
You could with Thompson's Water Seal.
This water damage is going to run $750. What would have stopped it?
Prevent water damage with Thompson's Water Seal. Simply brush Thompson's on wood, brick, or concrete, and it penetrates to form a barrier water can't get past, even when driven by 98-mile-per-hour winds.
This time, I'm going to protect my new deck with Thompson's Water Seal. A great defense against repair expense.
Value?
Absolutely. Our new Tandy 1000HX is made in the USA and designed to be one of the easiest to use PC compatibles ever. And it's priced for the home.
Just how easy is it?
Turn it on, it's ready to go. The whole family can use it for education, games, and budgeting. We even give you 7 programs to get started, including word processing, filing, and spreadsheet.
Easy enough, no better value.
Tandy computers, because there is no better value. Only at Radio Shack.
Third-ranked Miami taking on fourth-ranked Florida State. We'll take you back to Tallahassee and rejoin Brent and Era after this word from your local station.
This is CBS.
Junction Boulevard backed up 5-6 blocks. Rubbernecking delays have traffic backed out about half.
Contrary to popular belief, there are millions of miles of roads totally unfettered by traffic. And one car that will inspire you to get up earlier to find them. The new BMW 325i. With 39% more power than its predecessor, it has the singular ability to bring a whole new meaning to the expression, rush hour.
Test drive the ultimate driving machine at your Washington area BMW dealers.
Ryan Homes today, we've built a better way for America's dreams to grow. Homes so full of light, love, laughter, and life, our American portfolio. You've never seen homes like this.
Well, here's to the future.
We're gonna love it here.
Ryan builds a better way to live.
Countdown to kickoff. Sundays at noon on the one and only Channel 9.
A glorious day in Tallahassee for Florida State against Miami, but notice weather graphic. That wind, 15 to 20 miles an hour, it'll be blowing from the left to the right. The hurricane warnings are indeed up, and the wind will affect the passing game and the kicking games here this afternoon. You know, we think about Florida State. This is one of the most imaginative teams in all of college football. They have got a great coach in Bobby Bowden. What he told us yesterday is, when Miami expects us to pass, we're going to run and vice versa. That's the only way we can keep this great defense off of us. Now, Danny McManus on the left had the Seminoles ahead of the Hurricanes last year until he suffered an injury down in the Orange Bowl that knocked him out. And Ronald Lewis is his great outside flanker. Watch for the end around. We think of Miami, Pat Hayden, the great quarterbacks, Vinny Testaverde, but they're changing their image.
Well, their offense has been so entertaining the last few years, we've forgotten how good their defense is. They are sensational. In 2 games against pretty good opponents, 11 sacks, 5 interceptions, and no one has scored on this defense. 4 down linemen, which you don't see much in college football, they are led by Danny Stubbs. Now, he can rush the passer, and this is his kind of game, because Florida State likes to throw the ball, and he's ready. I guarantee you.
Take it easy, Danny. That's what
your teammates.
It's just warm-ups, yeah. He can really put some pressure on the passer.
You know, they've got a great secondary, Pat. You were telling me that it's the best in college football. And for more on that, let's go to a former defensive back. Here's our John Dockery. John?
They call themselves Benny and the Jets, and they are simply the finest defensive backfield in college football. And they are led by the finest defensive back in college football right now, number 36, Benny Blades, the free safety. He's an All-American and will most likely be one of the top five players picked in next year's NFL draft. But besides that, they're a unit that's played together for 3 years, and that gives them the communication, the chemistry, to be an outstanding group. And it was interesting talking to Danny McManus yesterday. He told me to complete a pass against Benny and the Jets, you have to make the perfect throw. And that's a large burden on any quarterback.
All right, John, and Benny and the Jets and the Hurricanes getting ready to come onto the field here at Tallahassee. This is a team that impressively has defeated both Florida and Arkansas. They went into the state of Arkansas and they leveled the Razorbacks a week ago. That Jimmy Johnson's alma mater, he did not treat them kindly. So they have risen to number three in the polls, thinking of going higher. Meanwhile, Florida State being led out by Renegade and Chief Osceola. State played alongside of the Miami players. They were high school teammates, and here come the Canes now. Jimmy Johnson, who has a tremendous road record during the regular season, having lost only once, and that was in Ann Arbor to Michigan. So it's coming your way, three against four. The shootout in Florida when we continue in a moment.
CBS Sports presents College Football. Live from Doak S. Campbell Stadium in Tallahassee, Florida, it's the Miami Hurricanes versus the Florida State Seminoles. Today's CFA game is sponsored by your Toyota dealer and the all-new Dimension 88 Corolla. Who could ask for anything more? AT&T, the right choice. Howard Johnson Hotels and Lodges. And by Wendy's, where you get the best burgers in the business.
Introducing Toyota Corolla for 1988. Dramatic new looks that'll literally stun you. Performance that'll surprise you. And value that is legendary. For 1988, it's a whole new dimension for Corolla. Toyota quality. Who could ask for anything more? Toyota.
Sir, would you choose hamburger A, a Wendy's hamburger that you can get your choice of fresh toppings on, or B, the competitions where they tell you the toppings you want?
B. I choose B because the toppings were picked by person or persons unknown to me, relieving me of any liability with regards to the B burger. And let me add that I'm happy to assist this investigation any way I can.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Most people like hamburgers with their choice of fresh toppings, like Wendy's, the best burgers in the business.
Lester's grandson's flying on business to the Far East.
How far? Dayton?
Nope, Taipei.
You can't get there from here. Anybody tell Lester?
No airline flies to more of the world from more of the U.S., the Northwest.
Hey, look at this. A free trip after just 20,000 miles.
Yeah, but it's...
To get that perfect photo, Eckert Ultralab 35, nothing looks better.
Wait till you see the changes we're making at Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson? This is Howard Johnson?
Is that wirklich in Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
If you haven't stayed with us recently, you may be in for a surprise.
This is Howard Johnson.
We're changing our rooms, our furnishings, and there's a new attention to service.
This is Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson.
traditions in college football. Chief Osceola on Renegade. The stage is set in Tallahassee. Let's go downstairs now to our John Dockery. John?
Brent, the noise level down here is incredible. I was in the locker room before the game with Bobby Bowden. He said, take it to him early, pound the line of scrimmage. You'll see a big physical early game plan from Florida State. And then there's a way out, they said, find a way. That was his thing, find a way to win. This is an opportunity. Now back to you, Brent.
Edgar Benes to kick it off for Miami. Last year, Florida State returned a kickoff with a trick lateral. Keith Ross to Dexter Carter. They're the two deep men again. Carter coming out. Short of the 20-yard line. The offense for Florida State here this afternoon, the trigger man, Danny McManus. Now behind him, he'll have Dexter Carter and Dane Williams starting. His wide receivers, Herb Gaynor and Ronald Lewis. And we get a late change. Sammy Smith, 33, will open at tailback here this afternoon. So they're going to go with the big fella, and they may pound ahead with it. On first down, they run Smith. And so, Pat Hayden, the stage is set for Bobby Bowden's strategy.
Very nice first play, off tackle with him, but Mark Salva is the center. He needs a key day today against George Myra, the middle linebacker. This offensive line of Florida State is a solid offensive line. The keys, though, I believe, are the tackles. The tackles have to play well, Tumberland particularly, against Stubbs on defense.
And a great tight end in Pat Carter. Upstairs in the coach's booth, they'll be watching to see if he can hold Stubbs out early. From the tailback spot, they come hard with Smith. Take a look at this Miami defense and what a group we've got. Up front, Greg Mark and Derwin Jones. As Pat told you, this is a 4-3. Stubbs and Bill Hawkins. Hawkins underrated. The linebackers, George Myra Jr., his father wants a quarterback at Miami. The outside men, Rod Carter, great pursuit from the backside. You got to watch him along with Randy Shannon. Marion Butts working at fullback. We have a timeout, Florida State, here early in the first half. Now, ordinarily, you would say, why waste the timeout? But Coach Bowden said, in the first half, I don't care when they use him. If there's a problem out there, get a timeout and come over. Now, obviously, McManus has been confused by the defense somewhat.
Well, there shouldn't be a problem, actually, on third and one, but McManus really did do the right thing. If, in fact, the play was brought in incorrectly, you call timeout, it's third and one. What you don't want to have here is a bad play and be forced to punt into this wind.
McManus out of Dania, Florida, actually went to his high school in Hollywood, Florida.
You know, Brent, you talked about Florida State being unpredictable on offense. This is a third and one. In short yardage situations this year, Florida State has thrown the ball 40% of the time, which I find remarkable. The defense here of Miami is keyed by two players. You're going to see Stubbs, who plays right here, he is the defensive end, and Benny Blades, who's out of the picture, who is the free safety. What they try to do is funnel everything outside, get everything to the boundary, bounce everything, and they have got great speed to run you down or to use the boundary as an extra defender.
Now they're going with the big bull backfield. 245, Butts at full. 220, Smith at tail. They bring the tailback into an opening for a first down. Bounds at the 37-yard line. First down for the Seminoles on an 11-yard burst by Smith.
You have to remember, Sammy Smith, although he weighs 220 pounds, he may be the fastest back in America. They say legitimately he runs a 4.340, which is awfully fast. That's motoring. The block of the tight end on the bottom of the screen is the key, and that is one of the big keys today. That is Pat Carter on number 22, Randy Shannon. He just kicks Shannon out and opens up a gaping hole for Sammy Smith.
Now McManus working against the wind on first down. They're going to keep it on the ground. They're moving the ball on the ground. Smith is the pivotal figure in this game so far, and they are getting to attack the linebackers. Now, one of the reasons why you've got to be careful when you pass, right here, Donald Ellis, Tolbert Bain, these names, it sounds like I've been reading them to you for the last 10 years, Selwyn Brown, and of course, the great Benny Blades. Now McMahon
Dennis eyeing that defense with a second and five. And again, running Smith. And the offensive line at Florida State doing a marvelous job. George Myra bringing him down, and he may have another first down on that run already in this game.
Brent, Florida State, I can't believe it, but ran five reverses in one game last week. And what they've done here in this first series, on three different plays, they've brought the flanker around and faked the reverse. They've given the ball to Smith, but everybody in the secondary is looking for the reverse.
That, of course, freezes up one of the linebackers. They must stay at home also, because it's a play that the coaches and the players looked at frequently down in Miami. One of the things that may have hurt Miami is the ease with which they beat Arkansas. They'll have to strap it on a little bit tighter here. They run the fullback right straight ahead, and that is Marion Butts, a sophomore out of Sylvester, Georgia. And again, George Myra Jr. in to bring him down.
We talked about one of the key blocks was the tight end, Pat Carter, against Stubbs, the All-American defensive end. This time he's just going to knock him out and take him completely out of the play. Now, Stubbs does take an upfield rush. But see the big hole right there? Big hole on the right side. Stubbs is actually stunning out of the play.
Dexter Carter checks in for the first time at tail. Here he is. He carries immediately into Miami territory, down near the 45-yard line. It'll be third. It's going to be almost 3 yards to go for the first down. Just about 3 yards they're going to have to get out of this third down play. Carter not as durable as Sammy Smith. Smith, after all, is 220, and Carter goes about 165. So the Miami Vice, if you will, what they have done defensively so far. But this, an impressive drive on the ground. Seven plays, all on the ground by the Seminoles. Here comes the end around. Lewis, the play they've been looking for, and he does not get the first down. Tolbert Bain, number 18, the first to hit him.
This defensive backfield of Miami play like linebackers. Tremendous support from Bain and from Blades, the free safety. Blades, watch both safeties, but Blades and the corners are up here, and they're going to come up and support on the reverse. Now, they're very plain discipline. They stay at home. The bottom of the screen is number 18, Bain. He turns it inside, and right there is Blades to make the stop short of the first
down. Bad snap to Rick Tootin, the punter. But he gets it off. He made the best of a bad snap. And it's down on the 10-yard line. Cleveland Gary, the punter, who punted for Miami's national championship team. Rick Tootin just saved the moment. We'll be right back.
I'm not going to take the blame for this. I've been a switchboard operator for 14 years, thank you very much. And just because someone at the top brings in a new phone system that's so complicated that no one can operate it, well, that's not my fault. Just to transfer a call, I've got to star 3, then 7, then push 3 of those feature buttons. And even then, I get the wrong person. It's ridiculous. It doesn't take a genius to know that a phone system that's causing all that trouble is losing your money. If you ask me, they should just scratch the whole system and cut their losses before it's too late.
Who will be in uniform? How well will they play? The NFL returns tomorrow on CBS Sports.
Not only did Rick Tootin punt for Miami their championship year of 83, but this summer he lost 20 pounds battling a form of tuberculosis. And here he is with a low snap coming away with a line drive punt. And doctors fearing he might spread the disease kept him out of school until late August. Now he takes heavy doses of antibiotics, and he becomes a key man in this game this afternoon. First and 10 for Walsh and the Hurricanes. Bad field position, and they run Williams with penalty markers down. That's why Williams stopped on the play.
And give that penalty to the crowd, Brent. It's awfully noisy down there, backed up into the end zone. Steve Walsh, the first thing he did when he ran on the field was talk to the official about the crowd noise.
Now, Steve Walsh and the offense.
Dead ball, movement of the offensive line, just the offense. Still playing first down.
A first and 15 from the eye with Bratton and Williams behind Walsh. Williams again. He broke the first tackle. Now let's meet these gentlemen. Walsh, the quarterback, you know that story. He replaces Testaverde. Bratton moves from tailback to fullback, but he's been there before. The wide receivers are superb. Benny's brother, Brian, and Michael Irvin, 47. And they're in a jam right now, Pat Hayden.
Miami has been absolutely unbelievable on offense, as you can see. 25 possessions and 15 scores. And Steve Walsh has pulled the trigger, made all the right decisions in his first two games.
They run Williams on the delay into the middle. Not wanting a mistake, not wanting to turn it over now. And that offensive line. Pat, what about this line? Rod Holder takes over center this year.
They are excellent pass protectors, Brent. What happens here is they go toe-to-toe, and you get very little pressure on the quarterback from the inside, and a very good tight end as well.
Now it is third down, and 11 yards to go for Walsh and the Canes. First pass, incomplete. Blades with a hand on it, and Deion Sanders, number two, ripped into him on that side. One of the best corners in college football. Now, get ready for an all-out attack on the punter. This is Florida State Specialty, and they have had Fiegels backed up here before. Look at that statistic. 22 punts and 6 field goals, and they got to Fiegels twice a couple of years ago here in Tallahassee. Pegues, the center, he's had some problems. It's a good snap. Under pressure, it's partially blocked. I believe somebody got to it. It'll go out of bounds inside the 50. They're going to get decent field position. A 31-yard punt. They come after him right away.
For a truck that'll make you wonder how you ever got along without it, Toyota Standard Bed. The one that sets the standard for compact trucks with the biggest standard payload in its class. And the solid value that makes Toyota number one in compact truck sales. Don't compromise. Don't settle for less than Toyota quality. Now who's looking out for number one?
Toyota.
Toyota! Who could ask for anything more?
Nothing protects the flavor of pure, natural beer like darkness. So before you open a bottle of Rolling Rock Premium, you have to open the box. We brew this beer the way fine imported beers are brewed, with all natural ingredients. And we brew this beer exactly the same way. Rolling Rock Light. Only 99 calories and all the taste of a fine imported beer.
Now when you buy a long-lasting Peerless faucet, you won't just get a 15-year warranty. You'll get a free NFL cap with your team's name and colors. We hope the strike won't last as long as our warranty. But who ever heard of a 15-year strike anyway?
Listen to the sound of a closer, smoother shave. Williams Electric Shave sets up my beard, so my shaver shaves closer, and I get a smoother shave. Listen to Williams Electric Shave. Mm. The sound of a closer, smoother shave.
Pat, in studying that replay during commercial, they did not get a piece of it.
No, but they hurried the punt. There was pressure right here from number 37, Stan Shiver, and Eric Williams, number 17, from the outside. And even though they didn't get it, they hurried the punt and only a 31-yard punt with a big win behind them. And again, that sets up the rest of the day to that punter's going to be concerned about that all day long.
Now, his protector took an outside man and let the pressure come right down the middle. The first place you got to check on a punt is for that leakage in the middle of that line, because that's the shortest distance to the punter if they can get through you there. But now, McManus and Florida State will take over. This is a first and 10 on the Miami 40-yard line. Butts and Smith, the full backfield back in there, and Smith on first down is hammered that time. That was Randy Shannon along with Greg Mark.
You don't see much four-down linemen play in college football because it's tough to find defensive linemen, Brent. But what Jimmy Johnson does is Miami, he recruits linebackers. He beats them up in the weight room for a couple of years, then puts them down in the line and puts their ears back. They've had great success turning linebackers into defensive linemen.
Passing spot against the wind. Let's see what Bowden elects to do here. He'll run Smith. Back through the middle. Hammering inside the 30. So when they expect us to pass, we'll go with the run.
Bobby Bowden's offense is always going to keep you on your heels. But I want to tell you, Daniel Stubbs is taking himself out of the play with an outside charge, and in the inside, you see Stubbs at the top of the screen. He is locked out. And then the fullback blocks right on Randy Shannon, number 22. And the fullback is a good lead blocker. Your tailback, your eye back, is going to pick up big yardage.
Pat Carter is doing a sensational job at tight end. We had heard he was All-American caliber, but he has been great. Oh, tremendous defensive play by Bill Hawkins, number 54. One-time high school teammate of Danny McManus. He just ripped in there that time. They both played in Hollywood, Florida.
You know, he is the underrated defensive end, Hawkins is, playing on the other side of Stubbs. And people forget about him sometimes because he's on the backside. But he is very quick off the ball. This entire front four crowd that ball and really get off of the snap count.
So along with Pat Hayden, I'm Brent Musburger, Tallahassee, Florida. Nice to have you here. This is number 3 and number 4. It's a dandy. A deep drop by McManus. And the receiver was all alone there. Hit him at the 23-yard line. That's the tight end, Pat Carter. So not only has he blocked, but he also breaks free to catch passes.
You know, Florida State really spreads the ball around. Their tight ends have caught 13 balls this year. That's the 9th catch by Carter. And when the tight end catches the ball, it means your quarterback is doing a very good job of reading the defense.
How good is Pat Carter? I had a coach tell me yesterday he may not be as good a receiver as Keith Jackson at Oklahoma, but he's a better blocker. This is 3rd and 5, and Dexter Carter comes in at tailback. This is Carter. He's cut off. Great defensive pursuit, and Daniel Stubbs makes the big play.
The old Stubbs was on the weak side of the formation, and again, that is his forte, chasing. Stubbs is number 96, and he's just going to chase down the line of scrimmage and use that tremendous speed he has to run the play down. Remember, the man is 255 pounds, but he is quick. That's what makes him a great pass rusher.
They may have to keep Carter covering him all game. And now Schmidt will attempt a field goal of 40 yards. Bad snap. Ball is free at midfield. Miami scoops it up on the run. And now Danny McManus comes back on it. It'll be Miami's ball right there. That was Randy Shannon who scooped it up at midfield. Hustling back, but a break for the Hurricane.
Well, this is incredible because Jimmy Johnson was so concerned about his snappers snapping the ball over the kickers and punters' heads. And here it comes through. It's actually over and to the outside. McManus is just trying to pick somebody out, and there is Randy Shannon to make the play. McManus is just trying to make something good out of a very bad situation.
First and 10 for Walsh. There was something unusual about that snap. We're going to show it to you again. I think McManus was checking for a spot and didn't expect the snap. I think the snap was a good one. I want to check it again. On first down, this is Williams, and he's buried by the Seminole defense, led by Eric Hayes. Pat, pick up this telestrator and center McManus where he's looking. Here's the snap. Now watch McManus on this, everybody. Let me see if we picked up something here. I think he's looking at the spot when the snap comes. You bet he is.
Yeah,
he never
right.
even saw it coming.
Yep.
He did not signal for the snap, and they hiked it to him, and that's what the problem was.
And that's the center's fault. His responsibility is to wait till the holder gives him the signal.
And now we've got a second down for Walsh. He'll pull out and throw it. Remember, he's the wind at his back, and hits the tight end, Henry, inside the 15-yard line. They get a first down. Miami threatening to score first.
When both of these two teams effectively use the tight end. Charles Henry caught six passes a week ago, and I want to tell you, when you've got a guy like Michael Irvin on the outside, you've got to be able to get the ball to your tight end because they're going to double up on your outside guys.
So the Seminole defense under severe pressure here. 4:40 to go in the first quarter and no score. Williams sweeping behind Bratton, and the Seminole defense was equal to that task. Greg Newell came up from the free safety spot, number 40. Now another man to watch was in on that stop too, and that is Paul McGowan, number 38. He's the linebacker and their leading tackler in this defense. They'll try to funnel things into his hands if they can. Now a second and 10, and days gone by. This was automatically a passing situation for Testaverde. Let's see what Walsh comes up with. They'll run out of it. They sweep Bratton. He cannot get the corner. Deion Sanders, the All-American corner, was there to haul him down, and they exchange pleasantries there at the sideline.
Yeah, this Florida State defense can run as well as the Miami team. They bounce it, the ball outside. That was supposed to go off tackle, but it gets bounced outside and pushed to number two, Sanders. You're not going to outrun him. Bratton's a pretty big back, but it's a good job of tackling there by Sanders. Goes high on it.
Now the third down. The ball is at the 11-yard line. They can get a first down inside the five. They will have formation shows Irvin in the slot as they back away from it momentarily. He's out to the left side of your screen. Now Walsh, who's having some difficulty being heard. Blades is 9 to his right. The call is at the line of scrimmage. He wants to be heard. Gets his protection. Incomplete. Irvin had not broken to the spot that time, Pat.
It was very good coverage by the entire secondary. He called the audible thinking that he could get the quick out, but exceedingly good coverage. Everybody is sticking. Irving's the man in the slot. He believes he can get him on the out route. See, there's a little bump there. He is not taken off, and the defensive back is right there on Irvin. No place to throw the ball.
Now it is Miami's turn. A 29-yard field goal attempt. And the punter, Fiegels, is the holder for Greg Cox. With the wind at his back, Cox puts Miami up by 3. The Hurricanes strike first here in Tallahassee. We'll be right back.
Avoid the noid with the Domino's Pizza Guarantee. We guarantee your pizza will be delivered within 30 minutes or you get $3 off your order. Guaranteed. And we guarantee your pizza will taste great. If you're not satisfied with your pizza, we'll replace it or refund your money. Only our pizza is guaranteed to avoid the noise. Domino's Pizza delivers. Call now.
It's a comfortable feeling. This feeling is good.
A nice, secure feeling to be understood.
Year after year, Nationwide Life Insurance gives blanket protection for you and those you love. And that's a good feeling.
A warm, special feeling, a feeling of pride.
A feeling of knowing that you're on my side.
Nationwide is on your side.
Refrigerator.
Will Steve's Heave-Ho give Jack his chance at romance?
Mm-mm. Not only is he cute, but he cooks, too.
My Sister Sam, tonight.
All right. So now Miami will kick it off. Last year, early in the game, Florida State came up with this play. Do you remember it on the return? Here is Ross. He fumbled on that sweep 5 yards deep. He's coming out. There's that famous lateral of Florida State's across field, and they've got an alley. He could go the distance. A year ago in Miami, and Bennis set to kick it off, and Jimmy Johnson said that play won't work this time. We have got a man covering both of the deep men. We'll see if Florida State doesn't have a new wrinkle. Well, that's one way. Drive it right out of the end zone. Let's go downstairs to John Dockery. John?
Brent, let me tell you what happened on that field goal, that botched field goal attempt. You see Marty Riggs behind me, number 51. Simply a case of the holder and the kicker not being ready. Riggs hearing a sound. It's incredibly loud down here, by the way, and snapping the ball when neither man was ready. They came over to him afterwards, the coaches did, and said, relax, calm down, it'll be okay. Now back to you.
That sometimes they don't use sounds on field goal.
Yeah, you really don't. Usually the quarterback with the guy who is holding will give you a hand signal that he is ready. So that shouldn't happen.
First and 10 for the Seminoles. McManus brings the offense to the 20. It's Smith, and he broke a tackle. Well, when you think about what Sammy Smith could become as a tailback, he is one who possesses world-class speed, and he weighs more than 220 pounds, and they have been waiting and waiting here in Tallahassee for Smith to blossom. Last year, he was injured down in Miami.
Well, he's a type of back you'd like to give the ball 25 times a game, but he has been getting nicked. He doesn't play well hurt.
8 yards to go for the first down. They'll run him again. You know who's over there. He will not get away from Mr. Stubbs.
I think the way Stubbs plays, Brent, you have to run inside of him because he takes that tremendous upfield charge.
Pat, that botched field goal seemed to take some of the life out of the crowd here, too. They're down. They trail by a field goal. And now Stubbs coming alive.
So he's playing outside shade on the tight end. Very difficult to run outside on Stubbs. Got to bring it up inside.
Third down, again, McManus going into the wind, and it's a stiff one. Off the draw, they run Smith. Great run by Smith. He breaks free. Goodbye. Oh, a tremendous tackle. He caught him. Bubba McDowell came after him and wouldn't quit. Smith.
Brent, Florida State, again, cannot run the ball outside, but they really felt they could run it inside from tackle to tackle. And Sammy Smith can break some tackles for you. He gets a terrific block there by Pat Tomberlin, number 72, and then it's all Smith as he breaks about four tackles. Now, it surprised me that he got caught from behind, but it showed you the tremendous speed that the Miami defensive backfield has.
Oh, McDowell did a great job of catching Smith. First and 10 at the 18, and McManus throws complete to Carter and out of bounds. At the 9-yard line, Benny Blades covering the tailback. I had an opportunity to ask McManus, how do you beat this Hurricane defense?
Main thing is when they think we're going to run, we got to do a short little pass. When they think we're going for the short little pass, we got to go for a long pass. Main thing we do is just keep them guessing at what we're going to do. That's a positive thing that Coach Bowden's been expressing to us the whole week.
Well, just what they did. It was third and 11 when they ran the draw.
Now on second down, they split the backs and they run Dexter Carter and Randy Shannon, the linebacker, ready for him. So they move the chains again, and they'll have a first and goal against Jimmy Johnson's defense.
And this is the part of the field where you're really happy you have a tight end who's a big target who can receive the ball like Florida State does.
Now, this first-team defense has not surrendered a touchdown this year.
A point.
Their two safeties came in the punting situation against Florida. The fullback and big Dane Williams. Stubbs finally rides him down.
Dane Williams he's going to carry the defensive lineman Stubbs about 4 or 5 yards, but Dane Williams is a great short yardage runner. 6 touchdowns already this season. Stubbs brings him down from behind, but he's 250 pounds, but Williams says no, and that's all determination down to the 2-yard line.
The power backfield, an extra tight end giving them three as the referee kicks in as time runs out on the first quarter. We've come to the end of the first quarter. Miami leads, but Florida State is threatening. College football on CBS returns after this message and a word from your local stations.
In a battle drill, you need horsepower, firepower, people power. That's teamwork.
Moving tank, track front, 2,000.
This team uses a computer, thermal sight, laser rangefinder.
Yeah. All that you can.
We win, the whole tank wins. The whole team wins, not just one person.
Find your future in the Army.
Too many people think a spark plug's a spark plug. Well, all spark plugs aren't alike. These AC copper core plugs match my car's specs like rounds in a chamber, firing up to 30 times a second for up to 30,000 miles of high revving firepower.
Precision AC Delco parts. They don't just fit, they match.
Keep your car running the way it was made to run.
Now get up to $7 back on AC filters and plugs. See your retailer for details.
You've got the whole world in your hand. You've got the whole wide world in your hand. You've got the whole world in your hand. You've got the whole world in your hand.
Put the whole world in your hand with Radio Shack's new portable cellular phone. A price and technology breakthrough.
You've got the whole world in your hand.
Only at Radio Shack, the technology store.
This is CBS.
I was on vacation from CMP Telephone Yellow Pages when...
Hungry, Joe?
Starved, Doreen.
So what's for lunch?
I thought you packed it.
First no bait, now no food. We're stuck.
Lucky I carry this.
The Yellow Pages.
Everywhere I go.
We're in a boat, Joe. Blue's on the lake. Live bait, fish and chips, lakeside view. Gas.
Need any help, Joe?
Look for the name CMP Telephone Yellow Pages. It's everything a directory should be.
Now Bridgestone has patented radial tire technology that doesn't compromise performance for mileage. Or mileage for a smooth ride. Or anything for anything. So at 65 miles an hour, remember patented radial tire technology. And remember Bridgestone!
Redskins Sideline, Saturday at 7:30 on the one and only Channel 9.
It's the game of the week in college football, and it's here on CBS. 3-4. Miami strikes first with a field goal in the opening quarter. Now, on a great run by Sammy Smith, who rushed for 103 yards in that first quarter, the Seminoles of Florida State have the ball at the one-yard line, second down. They rushed 17 times and passed only twice in the opening quarter. Dane Williams, the fullback, has been the short yardage first man for the Seminoles. Here he comes, behind the middle of the line with a second effort for the score. Touchdown on the season. And you can bet that McManus will kneel down this time and keep his eye firmly on that center. Derek Schmidt set for the extra point. Perfect.
This was a great drive, Brent, because they did mix it up. They got the big run, of course, from Smith, but mixed in two passes. It was culminated by this offensive line push. Good surge. No penetration there by that big defensive front. And then the last half yard was all Williams. Good block by Salva, the center. He gets off very quickly, cuts off his man, and Williams fights his way in for 6 points.
Once again, Toyota makes a great impact on the car world. For 1988, Toyota introduces quality right down the line. Cressida, Tercel, Supra, Corolla, Celica, MR2. There's quality, and then there is Toyota quality. For 1988, who could ask for anything more? Toyota!
To create new worlds, you need to see in new ways. Be curious. Look at the problem from another direction. Commit yourself to the long term. Keep your mind open. Look for breakthrough ideas. From aerospace to healthcare, we're creating new worlds by seeing in new ways. BASF, the spirit of innovation.
Strike is on. The replacements are ready. Where do you turn for the latest? To the NFL today, because nobody covers football better. Tomorrow on CBS Sports.
Mr. Jackson, you've got competition for All-American at tight end.
Pat Carter earlier blocked Stubbs. He's at the bottom of the screen outside. This time he comes right down inside and just buries Stubbs, number 96, on his back. That is a put down. And Pat Carter cleared the way for Williams. He's done a sensational job of blocking here in the first half.
So Richie Andrews to kick it off for the Seminoles, who lead it 7-3. Leonard Conley and Randall Hill are deep. With the wind at his back, it'll be down for the touchback. Well, tomorrow, I don't have to tell you, is going to be a very special day. As far as the NFL is concerned, obviously we've got stories that transcend football. What's going to happen at the various stadiums around the country at 12:30, we'll update it. Then these games all scheduled to be played tomorrow. How good are these teams? I don't think any of us know, so we'll watch with curiosity and see. The doubleheader game will feature Dallas and the Jets, Green Bay and Minnesota. So check your local listings and we'll see you tomorrow at 12:30 Eastern time. Our coverage begins. Walsh is back on first down. He'll put it up, and he hits Blades. Blades cuts back, and he's down at the 25-yard line. Matthew Mayhew, number 32, the corner on that side against Benny's brother. There's the team we'll see next week, Oklahoma and Texas, from the Cotton Bowl in Dallas, one we look forward to.
Yeah, Eric Metcalf is having a great year for the Longhorns, averaging 100 yards a game.
I imagine Keith Jackson will be ready for too, right? Now with second and 4 yards to go, Williams battles his way out to the 29. I believe he is short of the first down. It'll depend on where they spot the ball. He did get close to it.
You know, Brent, the Miami offensive line did a very nice job there. I don't think the Miami offensive line the last 4 or 5 years has really gotten enough credit. They've all talked about the quarterback. So those guys have done an unbelievable job the last few years of protecting the quarterback and then opening some big holes for the running backs.
Double tight end on this third and one. Roberts and Henry to lead the way. Bratton is the fullback.
Calling an audible. Dangerous on third and one.
They'll run Williams and he slips. He slips on third and one. Hayes did a good job of penetrating on that play.
Fulton Hayes, Fulton Hayes, 46, gets upfield very, very quickly. He beat his man quickly. And then when the running back Williams tried to cut inside, he slipped on the turf.
Now another punt for Jeff Beagles, who was under heavy pressure, and this time he's going into the wind. Just does get it off, and the Seminoles are getting closer and closer. Ball is down at the 37-yard line. A 35-yard punt. We talked about a lot of these players having grown up together, and they grew up down in South Florida. And here's where these two schools are located, Tallahassee, the capital of this great state. A breakdown of the recruits shows this. Miami pretty much stays at home. Florida State roams down into South Florida and came away with 13 players. So those 13 are seeing many of their former teammates and competitors from the high school battles. Or the state of Florida lately has turned out so many great football players. It's complete on the far side to Pat Carter, who is out of bounds at the 47. An 11-yard gain. What a weapon to have a tight end who blocks like that and then gets out and can catch.
And he's at the right of the screen right down. And the reason he's open because the wide receiver on that side, Lewis, is double covered by the corner and the strong safety. And a nice read by McManus. He comes back and sees the free safety is taking away the outside receiver and dumps the ball there to Carter. Easy throw.
Out of Sarasota, over on the West Coast. First down, and Carter stopped at midfield.
But you can see why this Florida State offense is difficult to defend, because we've seen a little bit of everything. We've seen reverses, we've seen throwing the ball downfield, we've seen the tight end catch the ball, we've seen some off-counter plays and some power football. They give you a lot.
McManus played his high school ball down in Hollywood at South Broward High School. He has the wind at his back, and he's in a passing situation, but they have been running on passing downs. This time, they will not. Quick throw over the middle, complete. So Carter with another reception. Let's check in on the Michigan State game, and here's Jim Nantz.
Well, Brent, a surprise brewing in Iowa City. Third and four here for Michigan State. Bobby McAllister hits Mike Sargent for the touchdown. Two-point conversion failed. However, the Spartans lead it with 8 minutes left. Let's go back to Brent and Pat.
Bobby McAllister plays his best games at Iowa. I was in there a few years ago when he played havoc with the Hawkeyes. McManus will set the screen, and it's to Williams, the fullback. He's got a first down and then some. Busts inside the 35. To the 32-yard line before Myra brings him down. A 15-yard gain and a good play call.
I'll tell you, a tremendous athletic play by Dane Williams. Then we saw him run tough down inside to score the touchdown. Here you're going to see a great catch. Then he picks up a terrific block by his center, number 63, Salva, and the wide receiver, Lewis. But watch the catch. I tell you, he's got very soft hands for a guy who can power the ball at you, too. 220 pounds. A couple of nice blocks by Salva and Lewis.
Gaynor and Lewis are the wide men. McManus, under pressure, avoids it. Oh. Incomplete, a dangerous throw. That was almost intercepted by Rod Carter.
Bad decision for Danny McManus.
Stubbs was coming after him. He would have been better off to chuck it out of bounds and not risk the interception.
It's interesting. Bobby Bowden told us yesterday his philosophy with his quarterback is do not get sacked on first and second down. Throw the ball away. But as you said, throw it out of bounds, not on the playing field.
And I can remember you being pursued by Too Tall and Randy.
And they caught me most of the time, too, didn't they?
Here's second too down quick. And 10. Split backs for McManus. On the delay, it's Carter. Zigzags his way into the arms of George Myra Jr. Columbia may break the Northwestern record after all.
You're hoping, aren't you?
I would never.
Northwestern grad.
Well, it's a third down and 10 yards to go here for Coach Bowden.
In the last situation they ran the big draw to Sammy Smith, the big game.
Edgar Bennett is the fullback. He's 22. Stubbs may have gotten across the scrimmage line too quickly. Hawkins in on him. The ball was free. There was a penalty marker down.
I think it was Tom Berlin, number 72, in motion, Brent.
A fierce rush that time. That's what Stubbs is motioning. That it was encroachment. So it'll be marked off, and Jimmy Johnson across the way. I think he wants it declined, Pat, if I'm not mistaken by his signal.
But I think the referees were calling the play dead. That's the dispute now. You're right, they would have declined it.
You have dead ball, movement on the offensive line, against the offense. Still third down.
So the ball is moved back to the 38-yard line.
Well, with Florida State now has the win behind them, remember, and I think all they really need to do is try to get 7 or 8 yards maybe to put themselves in position to try a field goal. They don't need to really get it all.
Now, they have a wrinkle in that wide receiver around when they bring him. They can throw off of that. That's one play that we did see them practice. Instead, they run a draw play, and he is stuffed. Carter couldn't find any running room that time.
Mr. Stubbs stuffed him too, Brent.
9 minutes and 42 seconds remaining here in the first half. Florida State leading Miami by a score of 7-3. Along with John Dockery and Pat Hayden, I'm Brent Musburger. Number 3 Miami against number 4 Florida State. Tootin's punt. And it'll bounce down at the 1. Florida State could not get to it and down it. It'll go in for the touchback. Come out at the 20.
I tell you, that is one of my pet peeves, though, when a punter doesn't punt the ball out of the end, on the 10-yard line. When you punt the ball into the end zone, you just give it up 20 yards. You got to punt the ball out of bounds.
A6, hurry and you'll make it.
Delta Airlines ticket agent Sam Singletary knows how to get people moving.
Franklin, you're back.
But sometimes he has to show off a few moves of his own. The kind of moves that made him a first-string halfback. Sam Singletary shares a feeling with everyone at Delta. He loves what he's doing. And it shows.
We love to fly.
He's the kid.
And it shows.
In Canada, the wind blows a little colder. The rapids run a little stronger. Some people say you can taste it in the beer. Molson Golden. A little crisper, a little bolder. Molson is Canadian beer.
If you could ask
for Toyota quality and get a truckload of free options. Chrome bumpers, free. Style steel wheels, free. Sports striping, free. Full carpeting, cloth bench seats, all free. $630 worth of free options on Toyota limited edition 4x4s. Priceless Toyota quality and free options. Now who's looking out for number one?
Toyota.
Who could ask for anything more?
Since Sammy Smith's 64-yard run, the Seminoles have gained only 7 yards on 6 carries. What about that story, John Dockery?
Let me just tell you about Sammy Smith. He seems to be okay. Bobby Bowden just came over and asked him, is he okay? He's shaking up a little bit. Might have been a little fatigue from the run, but Brent, he just shook his head that he's fine. We expect to see him back.
All
now
right.
Back to you.
Now it's Steve Walsh for the first down for Miami at the 20. Goes to the sideline, incomplete. Brian Blades, the intended receiver over there. So Steve Walsh follows in the line of great quarterbacks at Miami. Jimmy Johnson was not there when Jim Kelly was there. And then Bernie Kosar led Howard Schnellenberger to a national championship in 83. Enter Jimmy Johnson, and Vinny Testaverde became the quarterback. And they were beaten by Penn State in that great Fiesta Bowl, which led to the Nittany Lions title. Off the draw play, it is Bratton. And Bratton out to the 23-yard line with Mayhew tackling him. Oklahoma again impressive, and they figure to stay number one. Auburn with trouble.
Tennessee's a pretty good ball club.
Penn State on the comeback. They've got an appointment up in Syracuse in a couple of weeks that might be interesting. Third down. Walsh changing the call. He's got 6 yards for the first. This is Williams. It was well defended. Individual effort by Williams. But Kevin Grant, the linebacker, number 47, got in on him initially.
Steve made Walsh audible here to the option play. He thought he could get the ball outside, but there's too many defenders on the perimeter of the defense. With that many red jerseys on the outside, you got to run the ball up inside the tight end.
Well, the Seminoles have been close, rushing Fiegels twice. Let's see what happens this time. There's a lone back, a 10-man front. Gets it off high to Sanders, a superb punt returner at the 35. Beautiful return by Deion Sanders to the 48-yard line. A 16-yard return off a 38-yard punt, giving McManus and the Seminole offense good field position. So, Pat, how about an overview of this game for these two teams? We'll break away for a commercial. We'll come back, and we'll do that in a moment.
In places beyond the reach of other overnight delivery companies, you'll find UPS. Because unlike the competition, only UPS Next Day Air delivers overnight to every single address coast to coast. And because we're so efficient, we can do it for up to half what other companies charge. Whether the place is hard to reach or easy to reach. UPS, we run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
Wait till you see the changes we're making at Howard Johnson.
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
This is Howard Johnson?
Your face takes enough abuse, so you need the Gillette Good News Plus disposable. Its LubriSmooth strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. Good News Plus.
Everything's sexy.
Can I kiss you hello?
Sure you can kiss me.
When Everything's Relative premieres tonight on CBS.
You can pay a visit to the governor of the state of Florida here in Tallahassee early on a Saturday morning. You can walk downstairs, then you can take a pleasant walk and come on inside Doak Campbell Stadium. It's the hottest ticket in Tallahassee. Now, Pat, an overview on this game so far.
I've really been surprised how well Florida State has run the football. We expected them to throw the ball well, but I'm really surprised they had the big play by Sammy Smith.
Now, Victor Floyd, his first appearance this year, slowed by injuries. He has checked in at tailback, and they run Edgar Bennett, the fullback, straight ahead. And again, more successful running by the Seminoles.
And again, if you'll notice, it is inside the tackles. They've really done a nice job inside with a guard and centers, two guards in the center, controlling the inside.
Hand signals to Danny McManus. If you were with us last week, Ohio State had some difficulty with the 25-second clock. They were shuttling wide receivers in and out. Arian butts the fullback. Oh, hammered at that line of scrimmage that time by Stubbs.
I'll tell you, Stubbs' upper body is so strong. When you see him just practice, he's got those huge hands, and he just can just push you over and make the play. Very strong upper body. You can see that the Florida State offensive line has done a nice job of giving their backs some holes.
Well, here is third and short. If Bobby Bowden is true to his word, he'll come up firing here. Oh, a great play by McManus. First down.
They are just so difficult to defend. The impromptu or the unexpected play is just very difficult to defend. You're going to see McManus right here. He's the quarterback. He's going to fake the ball and then just run a naked bootleg. Now, again, it's a third and about a two or three situation. Everybody's expecting either your tailback to get the ball. They set this up by running the pitch earlier, and then he keeps it himself on the backside.
That was so good, you wonder if he even told the team what he was going to do that time. The way that was carried out. Now Floyd with his first carry to the 33-yard line, and Myra tackles him.
When an offense does that, runs reverses and bootlegs, the weak side linebacker must stay at home, or Bobby Bowden will continue to do that to you.
So Victor Floyd, three deep at that tailback spot behind McManus. Now Gaynor, his wide receiver, to the left. Time remaining, first half. Floyd cuts inside against the defense. The defense left a gap and some strong blocking. And he appears to be short of that first down. He had to get to the 25-yard line for a first down. Myra, again, who has been active at middle linebacker, bringing him down.
Again, one more time, they ran right at Dan Stubbs that time, Brent. And again, because when he's over the tight end, he takes an outside charge, and then they come inside of him. Let him take himself out of the play.
They run Bennett, needing to get to the 25-yard line. You know, there is a new image for the Miami Hurricanes on campus, somewhat quieter, and I asked Danny Stubbs if that was the way they wanted it.
I'd say we tone down like some of our actions, but it's just still the same kind of team we have, hard hitting and talking. And from the past years, we established like a reputation for ourselves, and we carry it on even this year.
Looking forward to the NFL?
I can't wait to get there.
They can't wait to have you either, big fella. If you don't do that, you can do voiceovers. That's one of the great voices. First and 10 for the Seminoles. They run the delay with the tail. Victor Floyd, the junior from Pensacola. And again, it is Myra. He's having himself a day.
Well, in a 4-3 defense, your middle linebacker has to be a guy who can run, who can play both the pass and the run. And Myra has done that this year for the defense. Covers a lot of ground inside.
9 tackles already with his father here in attendance. Those of you who remember his dad as a quarterback, he was one of the most entertaining quarterbacks in college football. He could dazzle you with those moves.
Sammy Smith's back in.
See if they go to him right away. They do, faking the end around, and Smith gets to the 20-yard line where Jimmy Jones was there. So again, they bring the fake of the end around, and somebody has to go with him defensively. Let's present this week's Toyota Leadership Award to those players who've been singled out for outstanding performance in the areas of team contributions and academics. Today's leadership winners are, from Miami, Selwyn Brown, their strong safety. He's a business management major from St. Petersburg. And David Palmer from Florida State, a pre-med major from Tallahassee here. Toyota donates a check for $1,000. A quick pass coming outside to Edgar Bennett is incomplete. I was on. Auburn beats North Carolina by 10. Let me finish up on that Toyota. A check in the amount of $1,000 goes to each school's general scholarship fund, so congratulations to both those players.
I don't think Jimmy Johnson has got enough credit as a head coach. We hear about all the problems that he's had there, but he's done a marvelous job of getting these guys ready to play, and he's now graduating over 70% of his athletes.
He took over, and they were graduating some 20%. That's a tremendous improvement. The snap is bobbled, but McManus gets it down in time for Schmidt, and he kicks a 36-yard field goal. Credit McManus. Superb job as the holder that time.
Is he waiting there for me? Take me where I long to be, in his open arms.
The Eagle GT Plus 4's unique footprint has 40% more tread grooves than America's best-selling new car performance tire. So rain or snow, you'll get the performance you've been waiting for.
The 1988 Toyota Celica. Its powerful 16-valve, 135-horsepower engine propels you to the limit, while you glory in Celica's sleek, aerodynamic shape. The 1988 Toyota Celica. The power and the glory. Toyota quality. Who could ask for anything more?
The number one team in the nation, Oklahoma, battles longtime nemesis Texas in one of the game's most celebrated rivalries next Saturday on CBS Sports.
So that's next Saturday. Here are the game of the week, Miami and Florida State, with the Seminoles leading 10-3, and Andrews set to kick it off. And now we're going to see Miami trying to come from behind with the young quarterback. That's a different position. Hammers another one deep with the wind at his back. So it'll come out on the 20-yard line. Let's go downstairs to John Dockery. Doc?
Thank you, Brent. I'm with Jamie Dukes from the Atlanta Falcons, the center. And, of course, you have an unexpected weekend off, an unwanted weekend off. What's the status of the strike now?
Well, as of right now, I think things are still up in the air. We're hoping for some movement. Supposedly, sometime this weekend, we're supposed to be getting together with management, and hopefully things will work out.
Is Atlanta holding together?
Oh, yeah, we're real strong. You know, we've got a good, solid group, and Mike Ken and Mick Luckers are really leading us. And so things are working out with us.
We'll find out as they're going to play this weekend. Okay, Brent.
All right, John, thank you. Now first and 10 for the Canes at the 20. Walsh will put it up. Good protection. Out of bounds. He overthrew Charles Henry on that far sideline.
He is throwing the ball a little bit high. I think, I don't know whether it's the wind that's affecting him, the ball is taking off, or he's not really following through and delivering the ball, but the ball is taking off on Steve Walsh. He's throwing now three passes high.
Steve Walsh is out of St. Paul, Minnesota. Has stepped in, won his first two games. That is something that none of their more famous quarterbacks were able to do. But he faces a test here this afternoon. Again, good protection. Down the middle for Blades. Complete. And Brian Blades, still battling, comes down at the 45, and he juggled the ball on that last hit. That's a 26-yard gain.
The things that have always impressed me about these Miami receivers is their ability to go over the middle. They're fearless. They're very tough receivers over the middle. And there's watch the good protection here for Walsh, and then he's going to step up into the pocket. We talked about the protection that all the quarterbacks receive. This one is well thrown over the middle, and then Blades out-toughs some defenders there for two more yards.
On first down, under pressure and brought down by Shelton Thompson, number 93. Now you can see Walsh wanting a timeout when he got up. Now that's only the third sack this year against Miami. Thompson responsible for it, and the Canes use a timeout.
I want my Serta.
Here's why people want their Serta. Only Serta goes beyond just being firm. We top our support with the extra comfortable Serta surface, a unique difference you can feel in a Serta perfect sleeper.
Marvin, I want my Serta.
Now's the time to get the Serta Perfect Sleeper you want at special reduced prices during the Golden Anniversary Year-End Sale at participating retailers.
All the right parts in all the right places. Napa's putting smiles on American faces.
Don't miss our biggest sale of the year. It's Car Care Days at your Napa Auto Parts store. Just about everything you need to keep your car in great shape is on sale now. Get special prices on quality Napa parts. Check your local newspaper for sale items at your Napa Auto Parts store and save at our Car Care Day sale.
All the right parts in all the right places. Napa.
The great quarterback tradition. Kelly, Kosar, Testaverde, and now Walsh at Miami. We mentioned the first two games. He won them both. Look what he had in comparison with the other three. Now he is wearing uniform number 4. Last year he was number 1, but he traded it because he said number 1 exudes cockiness. And I do not want to appear cocky in this role. I'll do the best I can, but I am not Vinny Testaverde. Hands it off to Bratton. And Bratton is down at the 43-yard line.
1:40 left, and Miami has two timeouts. Remember, they're going against the wind again, so they're going to have to get the ball up near the 20-yard line if they hope to get anything on the board.
Mel Bratton was the fullback the day of the Doug Flutie game in the Orange Bowl. So here's a big down for Steve Walsh. He steps up beautifully to Irvin. complete. They convert their first third down situation. Clock is stopped as the chains move. A 22-yard gain.
That was a sensational patience. The slot man here is Irvin's going to come down and run the post, but the key really was when Walsh stepped up into the pocket.
Without a huddle, they move quickly up. And the whistle sounded on the play before the snap. There was a whistle. Walsh takes that opportunity to go over to the sideline as the Seminoles call the timeout alertly before the ball was snapped. Now let's take a look at these two fine schools, Miami and Florida State, which is located right here in Tallahassee.
I came to University of Miami because I wanted a great education, and I wanted a school that cares about me. I'm majoring in psychology and minoring in communications. It's very challenging. Some of the best minds in the world are here teaching and doing important research that will change people's lives. For example, the Miami Project to Cure Paralysis is trying to find a way for me and a lot of others like me to get rid of these wheels.
Meeting the challenges of research and teaching, the University of Miami.
Acquiring the world's most powerful supercomputer, Florida State University has entered a new era in research capability. Already boasting such resources as a superconducting accelerator, FSU has bolstered its national reputation in the sciences and basic research. Researchers are pioneers in superconductivity, solving problems in health, and addressing the nation's fastest-growing state's needs in business, criminology, and the environment. A birthplace for critical new ideas, Florida State University.
Pat, the management of time becomes critical here.
We have two timeouts with 1:10. There's plenty of time to run and throw the ball.
Great pattern by Irvin. Stops the clock as he stepped out of bounds there. An 11-yard gain. He also got the first down. So Walsh looking very confident and poised on this drive so far for Coach Johnson and the Canes.
Michael Irvin has run two very disciplined routes the last couple of plays.
Only used 6 seconds for that play. Now it'll start at 104. Against the blitz. And that set up the hit. Paul McGowan cleans up. Terry Warren was there. The pressure came from the inside.
And Brent, I don't think you can run play action passes on a 2-minute drill. Everybody knows you're going to throw the ball, let the quarterback drop back and get his protection. But watch how he's going to run the play action fake here off tackle, and the middle linebacker is going to come up and get a piece of him. But again, it's a 2-minute drill. I think you give your quarterback the best. He can see the whole field by dropping straight back, and he maybe gets rid of the ball.
They have a tremendous tradition of great players here at Florida State. None better, of course, than Freddie Biletnikoff. Before he went on to stardom in the National Football League, he was a star here at Florida State back in 1962. Here he is, 57 passes. This one thrown by Steve Tensey. Then, of course, he played for the Raiders. And Daryl LaMonica, the Mad Bomber, threw him a lot of scoring passes like that. Now he's a coach in Calgary with the Stampeders, and he remembers what this rivalry is like.
You know, years ago, you know, we played them down there when Steve Tensey was our quarterback, George Myra was their quarterback. We upset them in the Orange Bowl. Last year, we went to the Gator Bowl that year and won. I even intercepted a pass off of mine, 99 yards in the end zone to the other, down the sideline, picked it off. I was a defensive back.
They'd like to have him in that secondary right now, facing Walsh and the Canes, who dropped back. Wanted Bratton, got the ball up high, and the blow is being delivered by number 44, John Walsh.
That ball hung again on Walsh. He's got to get some more zip on the ball, otherwise the defensive backs are going to kill the receivers.
Too many men on the field. They get off on the far side for Miami. Walsh, there's penalty markers down. He hit Henry at the 15. The linesman threw the flag. That would have been a 17-yard gain. Someone had jumped off sides.
But I'll tell you, it was a sensational throw there by Walsh and a great catch by Henry.
Big penalty.
Oh, boy. It's again, they're going against the wind. That would have put them in at least field goal position. You know, as a quarterback, sometimes you really get rushed in this situation when you have more time than you think.
Now the ball is put down at the 38. So this will be a third and 24 for Walsh.
Pick up maybe 10 or 15 yards, use a timeout, and kick a field goal.
What was critical was that penalty might have taken them out of field goal range going into the wind. That's what's going to hurt even more. Walsh against heavy pressure, incomplete. The rush was on that time. Stan Shiver, a safety blitz.
Florida State, here is Shiver right here. Florida State puts most of their pressure on the passer out of the nickel defense, and that's what this is. Shiver lines up like he's going to be covering the back, gets a nice jump on the ball, and then beats the tackle to the outside. Walsh had Irvin open, but Walsh had to throw it before he wanted to.
6 seconds and fourth down, and there's going to be a timeout called here by Florida State. So they're out of field goal range against the wind. And Walsh will take the opportunity to go across the way and confer with the Miami coaches. And, of course, coming up at halftime, the Prudential College Football Report with Jim Nance. A lot of football this weekend. Tomorrow, such a rare day. Pat, you have any thoughts about what we might see tomorrow around the NFL?
Well, I'm afraid you're going to see a lot of violence outside the stadiums.
Well, let's hope not. These are the games that are scheduled to be played. And it is a doubleheader day on CBS. Dallas against the Jets and Green Bay against Minnesota. And we'll be on the air at 12:30. Eastern time to see what the situation is at the time.
You know, Brent, when you were talking about Freddie Biletnikoff a little while ago, he defined the term possession receiver. How many third and six and eight passes did he catch over the years, not only here at Florida State, but in the pros as well?
Walsh with a headset on. He is checking with the offensive coordinator up in the booth.
Now, it is fourth and 23. Your philosophy here is maybe either throw the ball into the end zone and maybe come up with a big play with Michael Irvin, or perhaps a penalty, which would put you in field goal position. That's their two hopes.
6 seconds. Split backs, Blades, Irwin, and Andre Brown, the three wideouts. Down the sideline, incomplete.
Have to keep the ball in play to give Brian Blades a chance to go up and get it.
So it'll go over to the Seminoles with 3 seconds left, and Florida State will go into the locker room ahead at halftime. If there's a surprise so far, it has been the performance of the Florida State defensive unit.
And the way they've run the ball, Brent.
This defensive unit, Pat, may be stronger than we thought they were.
Well, you know, you always think about Florida State throwing the ball all over the field, but they do have some very good athletes on the defensive side of the ball this year.
Well, Miami scored first, and then it was that man right there, Sammy Smith, who turned the game around. His long run late in the first quarter ignited the Seminoles, and they went on to score 10 points. This was the run right here as he ran for more than 100 yards, 64 of them right here on the draw play. Watch the individual effort as he breaks a tackle. And then, somewhat surprisingly, he is caught from behind as Bubba McDowell runs him down. But it still set up a touchdown for Florida State. We'll be back after this message and a word from your local stations.
Hey, do-it-yourselfers, if you could take your family on a dream vacation anywhere in America, where would you go?
Oh, well,
how about New York, Washington, L.A.?
Yes, really
30
like
families will go anywhere in America when they win the Stanley Dream America Contest. Win free transportation on American Airlines, rooms at Holiday Inn hotels, rental cars from Budget, and up to $1,000 worth of Stanley too.
We go.
Enter today. Look for this display at participating Stanley dealers. You could go anywhere, even
Hawaii.
Why didn't you say so?
Sending a letter overnight was once a prerogative reserved only for the very rich and the very wasteful. Now, with the UPS Next Day Air letter, everyone can send a letter overnight. At a paltry $8.50, you may think of it as the overnight letter for the very smart and the very frugal. UPS, we run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
This is CBS.
How do you build a winning club? With a strong game plan. Take a look. This is a futuristic Holiday Express Center, like the one opening soon at Landmark Plaza, Alexandria. It's got the whole nine yards. More equipment, more certified instructors, even more savings.
Save 58% on a pre-opening charter membership at Holiday Express. Call now.
Want to be a part of the excitement? Here's your game plan.
Call Holiday today and save 58% on pre-opening charter memberships. Call now.
In the morning, you don't want to be kept waiting for the latest news.
My problem centers around my ex-wife and my daughter.
You don't want to wait for the latest weather, traffic information, and sports. At WTOP, we won't keep you waiting, no matter when you tune in.
That's today's weather. WTOP, top news stories and traffic next.
Come on up. Instantly on WTOP.
People who help people. You know who they are. That special person at work or at church. Those certain people who make a difference. Washington's unsung heroes. WUSA Television 9 is looking for 9 of these special people to honor them for all the work they've done in our community.
I'm Ron Townsend. As a part of Channel 9's long-standing commitment to the Washington area, we are establishing the One and Only 9 Awards. If you know a one and only person in your neighborhood, please write us today for a nomination form.
First Class Junkets at Taxpayer Expense, Monday on Eyewitness News at 6.
CBS Sports presents the Prudential College Football Report. Sponsored by the Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services. With the right choices, with the right guidance, the sky's the limit. The Prudential, your rock in financial services.
Well, welcome back to New York, the Prudential College Football Report. If there's a theme today in college football, a lot of teams opening conference play. As we show you now, as we go to the top 10, Oklahoma opening its Big 8 play against Iowa State. Not much of a game here. Anthony Stafford has scored for three touchdowns for the Sooners there. But Jamel Holloway, another big day for the quarterback, the Wishbone Wizard. 10 carries, 88 yards. He's already out of the game. Scored once on those 10 carries and threw for 2 touchdown passes. Now, Nebraska's going against South Carolina. This game's supposed to kick here in the next couple of minutes. Number 6, Auburn, a winner today at North Carolina, 20-10, taking advantage of 4 pass interceptions by Mark May. And Jeff Berger had 2 touchdown passes for Auburn there in that victory. Ohio State out in front of Illinois. That's in the first quarter. Tom Tupa has the Buckeye touchdown from 5 yards out. 10th-ranked Tennessee, rough week for the Volunteers, who were accused of covering up an in-house investigation. However, today, nothing but a lot of things to cheer about for the home folks taking on the Golden Bears. And here, Reggie Cobb. This guy is getting better by the week. He's only a freshman, and he scored 3 touchdowns today. Johnny Majors has a major league quarterback as well, major talent here. His name is Jeff Francis. Today, 21 out of 26, 222 yards. The screen here goes to Cobb. Again, Cobb with 3 touchdowns of the game. Tennessee wins it, and Johnny Majors 4-0-1. It's his best start since coming to Tennessee in 1977. Now tonight, Florida will play at LSU. The Tigers will open defense of their SEC crown in a big battle at Baton Rouge. 2 top 10 teams off today. Notre Dame next week will take on Pitt, and Clemson idle as well. Now other games involving ranked teams, UCLA in front of Stanford, 6-0 in the first quarter there. Michigan just rolled it up in the first half over Wisconsin. It was 42-0 at one time. Jamie Morris played only about 2 quarters, 18 carries, 182 yards, and 3 touchdowns for Jamie Morris. Morris. Temple and Penn State has just gone final. The Nittany Lions haven't lost to the Owls now since Pearl Harbor, but the big story for the Nittany Lions, the running back Blair Thomas. Here's a guy who will be a Heisman contender next year. Thomas had his career high, 24 carries, 167 yards, and two touchdowns. Texas A&M and Texas Tech. Here's a big upset. A&M back-to-back SWC winners. Today opening Southwest Conference play with a loss in Lubbock. And Wayne Walker catches the 76-yard touchdown pass from Billy Joe Tolliver to make it 14-0, and not even 5 minutes had elapsed in this game. And Tolliver went out for a few minutes. His backup came in. Scott Toman hit Irvin Ferris. 7-yard score, and the Red Raiders hold on to win it by the score of 27-21, and the Aggies again open conference play with a loss. Michigan State and Iowa, here's an upset. Number 17, Iowa losing to Michigan State. Hawkeyes had not lost a Big Ten opener since 1979. They opened the game at quarterback with Danny McGuire, and he was hot early. The touchdown pass there gave him a 14-7 lead, the Hawkeyes, but in the second half, he just wasn't effective at all. This is Lorenzo White picking up 19 yards. He had 39 carries today, 166 yards and a touchdown. But here's the game winner, 8 minutes left. McAllister goes to Mike Sargent, and Michigan State wins it 19-14 in the Big Ten opener for both teams there. And Georgia and Mississippi. Lars Tate has dressed, has not played. Tate, the number two rusher in the United States, but Georgia hasn't needed him so far. Bulldogs leading at Ole Miss by the score of 10-0. Now stay with us for more results as the Prudential College Football Report continues with scores from around the country.
If you can dream it, you can do it. Today, the Prudential can show you a new world of financial opportunities. Look to the rock for mutual funds, stocks, and bonds. Feel its strength in CDs, insurance, and mortgages. With the right choices, the right guidance, the sky's the limit. The Prudential. Your rock in financial services.
Find the holes in your homeowner's insurance before they find you.
Sorry to barge in.
Have a Prudential representative give you a fast, free pre-review of your coverage.
Are we covered?
If you had a pre-review, you'd know.
Get a pre-review from the Prudential and get a piece of the rock.
Doesn't look like Bermuda to me.
We continue on the Prudential College Football Report with some teams that are kind of down and out in college football, if you will. Of course, you have to start out with Columbia. The Lions are going to lose today. Their losing streak will tie Northwestern's losing streak at 34 in a row. Now, Davidson is going to lose to Dartmouth. It's a final now. It's just gone final. The Wildcat losing streak is at 16. Virginia Tech and Navy. Now, coming into today's play, Navy and Kansas had the longest Division I losing streak at 10, but now Navy's losing streak matches its total today, 11 in a row now for the midshipmen on the short end of the score. Speaking of Kansas, the last time the Jayhawks won was against Southern Illinois, but the Salukis leading right now at halftime in that game. Here's a contest between two schools that were 0-7 coming in and had been outscored by a total of 292-91, but it's Tulsa taking it out right now and K-State at halftime. Now you talk about the other side of it. Syracuse, what a success story this year. Best start since 1960. Tied up with Missouri, though, 10-10 on the road, the Orange today. Both teams in this game have committed four turnovers in the first half, so real sloppy, and it's a 10-10 tie there. Now, Big Ten opener for Northwestern and Indiana. Hoosiers lead it. Next week, the Hoosiers will go against the Ohio State Buckeyes. NC State today shut out Georgia Tech. First time in 54 games that the Yellow Jackets had been shut out. West Virginia 49-0 over East Carolina. Freshman quarterback Major Harris today threw for two scores, ran for another. Kentucky over Ohio, fourth quarter there, late going. It's Kentucky homecoming day, and they are taking advantage of that. Wake Forest won at Army, best start for the Demon Deacons since 1967. The great Army quarterback, though, the man who runs the wishbone, Torrey Crawford, went out with a knee sprain, will be out for 4 weeks. His backup, Mark Mooney, came in, put Army in front in the fourth quarter with that one-yard keeper at 13-10. But under 3 minutes to go, Wake Forest, playing on the road, had their outstanding quarterback, Mike Elkins, to Ricky Prohl, 27-yard score. That was the winner. And Wake Forest is now 4-0 on the season, next week visiting North Carolina. Let's get to the Ivies, where today Brown takes on Princeton, and Brown wins it to go now 3-0 on the year. Harvard over Bucknell, this game in the late going. Harvard 2-0 on the season, trying to increase its record to 3-0. Holy Cross and Colgate, the 50th meeting between these two schools. Now, Gordy Lockbaum got so much of the preseason attention for Holy Cross, but right now, he might not even be the MVP on his own team, so how could you give him the Heisman Trophy? Jeff Wiley, the quarterback, last week threw for 7 touchdowns. Already in this game, he's thrown for 2 more scores, or make that 3 scores now, and 300 yards passing. Jeff Wiley, the real story now for the Crusaders, who are ranked number 1 in Division I AA. Let's move out west now. Utah and Air Force. Air Force winning over the Utes. Air Force cannot afford another loss in the WAC. They opened the season with a loss against Wyoming, but winning today by 3 scores. Battle out in the Rocky Mountain State. It's Colorado beating the Rams there by 16. Wyoming and San Diego State. This is a game that's supposed to be a real air war at Wyoming, and the Cowboys lead it by 4 in the second quarter. And in baseball, Toronto and Detroit coming into today's play in the American League East, all tied. Of course, the regular season ends tomorrow. What a game this is. 6th inning, all tied at 2 apiece. Now, when we come back, we'll take a look at how some of the Florida State players are keeping the barbers in Tallahassee busy as we continue on the College Football Report.
Beyond your expectations. Today, the Prudential can show you a new world of financial opportunities. Look to the Rock for stocks and bonds, mutual funds. Feel its strength in CDs, insurance, and mortgages. With the right choices, the right guidance, you can move mountains. The Prudential, your rock in financial services.
Muggsy, stay.
Make sure your auto insurance is under control. When your car's not, have your Prudential representative give you a fast, free pro review of your coverage.
Are you covered?
I don't know.
You'd know with a Prudential pro review. The right coverage is no accident.
Oh,
Muggsy. Get a pro review from the Prudential and get a piece of the rock.
Nice boat.
Let's update a couple of scores for you now here at halftime on the College Football Report. Ohio State, Matt France has kicked the field goal. Second quarter now, Buckeyes leading it by 10 at Illinois. And also UCLA and Stanford. UCLA lost last year, by the way, to Stanford, avenging that now with 3 field goals in the second quarter. Now last night, Brigham Young beat Utah State by the score of 45-24. But the real story of the game was senior defensive back Kirk Davis of BYU. Earlier this season, Davis learned he had Hodgkin's disease, a form of cancer. But despite the seriousness of this illness, Davis says his strong Mormon faith will keep him going.
When the doctor told me it didn't really shock me. I just looked at it as something I'm going to have to get through. I guess it's from my missionary background, being shocked by so many people, things that people have said, you know, things that people's belief. I guess it's just my religion that makes me not really shocked about, not worry about it.
Last week, Davis not only recovered a fumble, but he intercepted this pass and returned it for a touchdown in the Cougars' victory over New Mexico.
I saw the ball come all the way from his hands right to mine, and I just said, nobody's going to catch me now. I'm just going to go. So I took it and went.
Doctors believe they've caught the cancer in its earliest stages. But yesterday, Davis was informed he would need an operation, and he still played.
The doctors told me my options. The team said get healthy. Lavelle said get healthy. The doctors gave me the option to play next week, my last game. And so I took that option to help the team because I know their need for defensive backs right now. I don't want to let anything slow me down. It's probably just something in my family. We never give up, and I'll never give up on this, and I know I can beat it. And if I come back this year, and you know, that's fine. If not, I'll work out, and I'll be stronger and bigger and better for next year.
Davis will play next week against Wyoming and undergo his operation on October 12th. All of us here at CBS Sports wish him the very best. Now, before we send you back to that game in Tallahassee, this fashion note. In picking its nickname, Florida State chose to honor Florida's original native sons, the Seminole Indians. But when it comes to hairstyles, the Seminoles march to a different beat. The one heard on those drums, along the Mohawk.
First glance at the Florida State team photo, you may not catch the current hair-raising issue in Tallahassee. But once you go behind the scene, you do take notice.
I mean, we were just sitting around one day and decided we want to do a little something off the wall for what we think is going to be a big year.
Both of us are seniors, and our last year, we wanted to look a little crazy going out.
So far, more than 20 players have been clipped. But the real buzz on this club is if they stay razor sharp and unbeaten. Coach Bobby Bowden will join the ranks.
He said if we went 11-0, he'd shave his head a mohawk.
Well, I tell you, it couldn't get any uglier. But I think the odds are so great, I don't think I have to worry about it.
We took this a step further. This is Bobby Bowden now. We got with our artist, and should they go 11-0, the Seminole coach will look just like this on January 1st. Bobby Bowden, if his team wins all the regular season games, the Mohawk is coming. And back out at the remote, that is a picture that's been put together by the Florida State players. They're thinking now, a perfect season. And again, Bobby Bowden says he'll keep the promise alive and he'll get the haircut as well. Well, they're leading right now, Florida State 10-3, and we'll send you back to the second half in just a moment. I'm Jim Nance in New York. Thanks again for watching the Prudential College Football Report on CBS.
The Prudential College Football Report has been sponsored by The Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services. With the right choices, with the right guidance, the sky is the limit. The Prudential, your rock in financial services.
Former college football player Charles Reed.
When I graduated from high school in Western Pennsylvania, it was a football scholarship that allowed me to go on to earn my bachelor's and doctor's degree at the George Washington University. Without those degrees, my career would not have been the same. That's why I'm committed to seeing that our athletes graduate on time, because education is what universities are all about.
The preceding brought to you by the College Football Association. From football to speech, from basketball to band, more than 10 million boys and girls enjoy the benefits of high school activity programs. These programs provide valuable lessons in teamwork and sportsmanship. They're offered to the nation's youth at a cost of only 1 to 3% of most educational budgets. Support high school activity programs, the best bargain in education. This message brought to you by the National Federation of State High School Associations.
It's been a tough defensive game here in Tallahassee with the Seminoles leading the Miami Hurricanes 10-3. I'm Brett Musburger along with Pat Hayden. And Pat, what are some of the stats that jump out at you?
Well, the play selection, I think, is an interesting thing. Although Florida State has only thrown 7 passes, they've been successful on 5 of those. You came in thinking you were going to have to really defend the pass. You see, they've run 31 plays. Now, Miami is well-balanced, but they have not run the ball well.
Now, if we look ahead to the second half, what must they do?
I think what Miami has to do is come out with a drive and really try to drive the ball with the running attack. They haven't gotten any production out of that, but to get Walsh and give him some help is to run the ball well.
Yes, somewhat surprisingly has been the performance of the Florida State defense. Against the run, they have been stringing it out, and the longest run against Florida State in the first half was 5 yards. Now, we have seen Bratton take over and dominate a game in the past, but not here this afternoon against the Seminoles, Pat.
Well, this play was designed to go off tackle, Brent, but they've forced the defense forces him to bounce it outside. They're forcing Bratton to bounce the ball outside and right into their speed, their secondary. Sanders, number 2, comes up and makes a very good tackle on a man who's difficult to bring down in the open field, and that's Bratton.
All right, so while we've got an opportunity, let's send you down below now to John Dockery. John?
Thank you, Brent. I just talked to Jimmy Johnson. He said the problem is, as you said, at the line of scrimmage. They haven't been able to run the ball. He said, we will come out throwing in the second half. We need better field position. It's been a problem. The defense from FSU has dominated, but he said, you'll see us throw the ball a lot more in the second half. Now back to you.
All right, John, thank you. Well, Jimmy Johnson normally has had difficulty with Florida State in the first half. Nothing unusual there, but we'll see if they can rally after this break and a word from your local stations.
Fans, please.
Mr. Garfield, welcome to Embassy Suites Hotel.
My room,
Oh, all our rooms are really two-room suites for the price of a single room.
Beautiful. Don't change a thing.
The living room, sir.
Love what you've done with this room.
The bedroom.
This is great. I need my space.
And of course, you'll want to take advantage of Embassy Suites' free breakfast.
Food.
Served every morning.
At Embassy Suites, you don't have to be a fat cat to enjoy the sweet life.
I resemble that remark.
My brother used to have remotes all over the place.
They were everywhere.
A TV remote, a cable remote, a VCR remote. Yeah. My brother was very confused.
I was very confused. I don't even know how to work this.
Then my brother bought a Magnavox TV with this amazing new remote. And Magnavox invented it. It's three remotes in one. It controls the Magnavox TV it came with and just about any other brand of wireless cable and VCR. So my brother's not confused anymore.
Yeah, and neither am I.
Sure are.
I did it! I did it!
Did what?
I just invented the wheel!
May I make a suggestion?
Sure!
Try these.
What are they?
Monroe Gasmatic Shocks. Oh. They'll give you the best ride ever. Guaranteed. Monroe Shocks and Struts are the next best thing to the wheel.
Guaranteed?
In writing, pal.
Wow. Hey!
Yeah, great ride!
Looks like we won't have to reinvent the wheel for another, million years.
Hey, no wonder America rides Monroe!
This is CBS.
In Canada, where this is considered social climbing, you don't make a faint-hearted light beer. Now there's imported Molson Light.
Now there's a frequent traveler program that can guarantee you Christmas in Hawaii. It's Pan Am World Pass. World Pass has no holiday restrictions, so you can celebrate St. Patrick's Day in St. Thomas. World Pass has no seat limitations, so you can celebrate Thanksgiving in Turkey.
To join and get the details, call Pan Am. Who knows, you could be celebrating New Year's in New Delhi.
Pan Am World Pass. Holiday travel guaranteed.
Washington, where there's a wheel, there's a way.
Well, this is it. You ready?
All eyes are turning as the big wheel keeps spinning.
I'm ready.
Watch Pat Sajak and Vanna White make your million-dollar dreams come true. Join the Wheel Watchers, weeknights at 7:30 on the one and only Channel 9. Countdown to kickoff, Sundays at noon on the one and only Channel 9.
Florida State to get the ball with a 10-3 lead to start the second half. Bennett to kick it off for the Hurricanes. The wind at Miami's back, which means that Florida State will have it there for the final quarter. A very important factor. Fielded by Carter. Cuts back. Out to the 31-yard line. A slick return by Dexter Carter. And Sammy Smith, number 33, will open at tailback this half for Florida State.
Brent, we'll see what kind of adjustments the defense makes here because they really didn't come up with many negative plays there in the first half. That's characteristic, ordinarily, of the Miami defense.
Marion Butts is the fullback set in front of him. Lewis and Gaynor, the wide receivers. Smith on first down. Gets to the 35-yard line before Randy Shannon, who is battling an injured ankle, brought him down.
He opened up with the same play, really, that he ran the long play on, and that is Smith when he ran for 70 yards or 60 yards. Same play opened up the second half with.
Well, there's the first ever Division III team to win 500, and congratulations to Wittenberg. And meanwhile, Columbia loses for the 34th straight time. Edgar Bennett in at fullback. McManus runs the draw again, and it's good for a first down out to the 44-yard line. Bennett, the ball carrier, and Carter tackles him.
I'll tell you, a draw is a terrific call against a four-man line when you have aggressive defensive front because the Miami defense really likes to come upfield. And this was a terrific call on second and long to give the ball to Bennett on the draw, and he picks up the first down.
Good defense against Bennett that time. They were ready for it. Bill Hawkins led the way. So this will be a passing situation on second down. And it was in a similar setting against the wind that Florida State shocked Miami with a draw play that bolted free for 64 yards. This time he throws quickly to the wide out. Lewis on that far side, and he is defended by Donald Ellis.
That's a dangerous throw against this defense because those defensive corners can really drive you, drive on the ball.
It's too risky. He'd have hung that one in the air.
That's a too risky of a throw for a two-yard gain. Now a third and seven situation, Florida State earlier in the first half threw a screen pass here, Brent, to Dane Williams for a big play.
Protection and he takes off, dumps it to the tight end. Great catch at the 40 by Pat Carter, number 85. 13-yard gain for a first down.
Danny McManus does a nice job of buying himself a little extra time here. A very good rush by the Miami defense. He steps up into the pocket, avoids a little bit of rush, and then finds Carter. Then he'll make a terrific catch, and actually he's signaling that he catches the ball before he even hits the ground.
Carter is playing like an All-America here this afternoon, isn't he? First and 10. Some great tight ends in college football. We'll see Keith Jackson next week. And they bang with Sammy Smith. And a big bang. Brought down by Selwyn Brown. Second down, and about 4 yards here for the first down. McManus getting the play from Bobby Bowden's sideline. Slips, gets back up, and throws incomplete. Pat, what's interesting is that in passing situations so far in the second half, both of Bowden's backs have been going out into patterns, which means that the coaches upstairs think that that offensive line can handle the rush.
Well, they're running short routes, too, and McManus has done a nice job of getting rid of the ball quickly. And there he did a nice job of avoiding the sack. Again, it's one of Bobby Bowden's rules. Don't take a sack on second down.
McManus eyeing the sideline for that hand signal. Now the change in personnel as Dane Williams, and a timeout is used here by Florida State. Bobby Bowden not happy about it, but he'll use one anyway.
When the sun goes down, gonna light up the night. Silver Label Red Ribbon, a taste that's right. Gonna light up the night.
When you have miles to go and promises to keep,
listen to the heartbeat of America.
You could just discover new Chevrolet Corsica and find not just a sports sedan with exceptional road performance, but a sports sedan designed to keep all your promises.
The heartbeat of America.
Corsica.
That's today, Chevrolet.
Her car just died. An uninvited guest drops in for dinner, and she almost gets her date killed. Legwork premieres tonight on CBS.
CBS Sports presents College Football. Today's CFA game is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. Michelob Light. When the sun goes down, light up the night with Michelob Light. And by Kentucky Fried Chicken. Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right.
Florida State's football team wasn't much in the 50s, but they had a great drama department here in Tallahassee, and they turned out a very well-known actor by the name of Burt Reynolds. What you may not know is he was also a running back here for several seasons, And we now welcome Bert, who is perhaps the most loyal follower of this football program. Bert, nice to have you with us this afternoon.
Thank you,
How do you think this game's going so far?
Well, it's going exactly the way I wanted it to go. I'm absolutely thrilled. I'm kind of shocked that Bobby isn't throwing the ball more, but he wanted to take the strength to the strength, and he has Sammy Smith in there, which is also kind of a surprise, but he's our big back, and he's doing a great job.
I know you were down on the field with some of the players, and you were over in the locker room. What was the mood with the Seminoles before this game began?
They were amazingly loose. I was surprised. I didn't see any of those heads banging into lockers that we always do in movies and stuff like that. They were very loose. I said to McManus, you own Miami, you know? He said, yeah, I know. So what do you can say?
There is a clock problem here right now, and that's why we're having to delay down on the field. And Bert, I know that you have made it a point to come to the games back here, in fact, even scheduling your movie career around that, but tell us about the time that you went out there with the flaming spear and threw it down at midfield at night. That must have been a great throw.
Well, that's an amazing feeling of power. You know, you hold that spear up and 70,000 people stand up. It's quite amazing. It's better than an Oscar. I can say that because I've never won one.
Well, stay right here with us and watch a few plays with us, Bert. Nice to have you alongside us here. We've got third down now for your Seminoles, who have played very well, and McManus pulls out. Complete. He hits Gaynor at the 21-yard line, defended by Benny Blades. A 13-yard gain, and there's that pass play you wanted, Bert.
Well, he's been setting it up all day.
The key here was, again, very good protection for McManus, and he gets rid of the ball so quickly. Gaynor started on the outside and found a dead spot right there in the middle of the field, and then McManus just drilled it. The key was the protection and McManus getting back and getting rid of the ball very, very quickly.
And a big hit by Blades after the reception. So McManus, 8 of 11 for 74 yards now with a first down. And here he is running Carter, who slips and is tripped up there at the 20. Selwyn Brown coming in on him. Bert, the national championship. What's your feeling about that as far as this team is concerned?
Well, I think they've proven a lot today if they go on like they are. And I saw where Michigan State upset Iowa, and they really crushed Michigan State last week. Also, Texas Tech is on its way to an upset, who they beat very badly. So I think they've proven that they are a national contender.
Well, here is a second down for the Seminoles, threatening again with a 10-3 lead here. And they run the big back, Smith. Brown bringing him down. I must tell a marvelous anecdote that Bobby Bowden passed on to us yesterday. You know, it's illegal for the famous graduates of schools to recruit unless they are also professors. So lo and behold, who is a professor of drama down here in Tallahassee? Why, one Burt Reynolds. And Bobby said, you know, he just went out there and three mothers signed up right away.
Yes, and they're very good tacklers, too. I'm 4 for 4 with mothers.
This is the program that Bobby Bowden turned completely around about a decade ago when he came down here from West Virginia, a coach who was born and raised in Alabama. Good protection from McManus. Over the middle, and another completion to Herb Gaynor. Rod Carter defending him, and now Pat Hayden, he is starting to find those receivers in the middle.
And Brent, I think this kind of pass was set up earlier in the game when Florida State threw the ball to the tight end so much. Everybody's concerned about the tight end. Gaynor runs a little delay route after the tight end had cleared the middle out, and it was an easy throw for McManus. Good play selection by Florida State.
And a decision here for the coaching staff. They are in fourth and short right now with a 10-3 lead. 8:45 to go, and they're going to call a timeout. Now, that is two of their three timeouts that have been used here in the third quarter. So McManus will huddle up, and Bobby Bowden will make his decision. Big moment.
In places beyond the reach of other overnight delivery companies, you'll find UPS. Because unlike the competition, only UPS Next Day Air delivers overnight to every single address coast to coast. And because we're so efficient, we can do it for up to half what other companies charge. Whether the place is hard to reach or easy to reach. UPS, we run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
A leading consumer magazine has just cleared the air. Of all oil filters tested, the new Fram WearGuard was rated best. Fram, you can pay a little now or a lot later.
Take good care of your car. But forget your brakes. Might as well do this. Bendix brakes pass tougher tests than any law requires. So think about Bendix. The sooner, the better.
No better value.
Right. The new Tandy 1000TX is made in the USA and has incredible speed at an unbelievably low price.
Speed?
Six times the speed of the PCXT, so you're more productive at home or work. It's ready to run on a built-in 3.5-inch disk drive, and we give you seven PC programs, including word processing, filing, and spreadsheet.
That is better value.
Tandy computers, because there is no better value, only at Radio Shack.
Burt Reynolds, your chance to meet John Madden and Pat Hayden here at the Telestrator.
I can't pass this up. This is Tomlin here, who's was waiting for this matchup all day. Watch how the fullback and he double team on the steps when he comes in.
It takes two men to block Stubbs, but he did a nice job of doing it.
He passed his first test. I think Bird make a pretty good analyst. He knows how to make that circle all
right.
If I
can only act.
That's right. Yes. I don't ride trains either.
All right. Derek Schmidt is in here on fourth down. Now, remember, Florida State faked a field goal a year ago in Miami and lost McManus, who was injured. This time, Schmidt's kick, no good.
Brett, that was another bad snap. It's a third one we have seen today on field goals.
Yeah, when we were out there at practice, you know, Bowden was telling me that he was going to go for the punts every time because they've been very successful with Miami center. And the ironic part about it is we've had all the trouble all day with the center.
Low snap again. McManus did a nice job of getting the ball set, but the timing was off, I believe.
So it stays at 10-3, and that could be a big miss as this game continues to unfold. Now it's the Canes' turn with Walsh at quarterback, Warren Williams and Mel Blatton. They'll try the running game again. Nowhere for Williams. This Seminole defense has been savage. The longest run so far has been 5 yards. Let's go downstairs to John Dockery. John?
Thank you, Brent. I'm down here with a man that Miami certainly could use, Alonzo Highsmith. What's the problem today? They can't seem to run the ball.
Basically, I think...
He said he was going to do that before the game, and he did it, and that's amazing.
Now they've missed an extra point. So Schmidt misfires on a field goal, and now an extra point, which leaves it at 16-3.
The right part of the screen is Martin Mayhew, number 32. He's the one who comes in and makes the play. He's one more out. He blocks it, and another defensive back, number 26, Williams, makes the recovery.
Academic All-American, Pat.
Bert, thanks for dropping by.
Thank you,
Brent. The Seminoles a touchdown.
I enjoyed it very much.
All right.
Thanks,
we'll continue in just a moment.
Chicken Little's just a walking down the street singing. Kentucky Fried Chicken's got my favorite thing to eat singing.
Kentucky Fried Chicken's new Chicken Little sandwiches. They cost just a little, but people love them a lot.
Your face takes enough abuse, so you need the Gillette Good News Plus disposable. Its lubri-smooth strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. Good News Plus.
Now when you buy a long-lasting Peerless faucet, you won't just get a 15-year warranty. You'll get a free NFL cap with your team's name and colors. We hope the strike won't last as long as our warranty. But whoever heard of a 15-year strike anyway?
The number one team in the nation, Oklahoma, battles longtime nemesis Texas in one of the game's most celebrated rivalries next Saturday on CBS Sports.
So Alfonso Williams, a junior out of Lloyd, Florida, scores the touchdown. Now the Seminoles solidly in command, 16-3. Andrews is the kickoff man. Fielded at the 15. And down at the 28. So tomorrow, a very unusual day in sports. The strike update at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Time on CBS. We'll have reporters stationed at all these various ballparks, and we'll check in. And these are the games that are scheduled. And I know that there's a lot of curiosity about these games tomorrow. How good are these replacement teams? Are there some mismatches now with those players who come across the strike line?
I think
those are all questions we're going to be answering.
And Brent, I think the time of possession really has been significant. Often it is, but today it has been.
Walsh, with time, underthrows the receiver, and that was Williams who had come out of the backfield. And now the Florida State youngsters are aggressively climbing verbally up on the Hurricanes. Through the years, opponents of Miami have said that they talk more than any team they've been around, and I believe that some of the Seminoles now are going to repay that favor as long as they've got them down.
Miami is looking for a leader, Brent, and this is the time when Steve Walsh or Williams or Bratton is going to have to step to the forefront and lead this team.
His last five passes have been incomplete. They run Williams on the delay in a passing situation, and the Seminoles now in hot pursuit.
One of the things the Seminoles have done a great job on defense at, and that is mixing up their coverage. Sometimes they're coming after Walsh and blitzing, and other times they drop off in coverage. Walsh looked confused.
I said at the top of the day that perhaps the worst thing that could happen to Miami prior to this game was an easy win over Arkansas. Before the game even got started, it seemed to be a very relaxed Hurricane team out here. There was a little more passion exhibited by the players on the Florida State side. Sometimes you can't tell anything by that, but it is an observation. Again thrown high. Williams working the far sideline, and Miami must punt it away. And the Seminoles can come again.
Bobby Bowden, too, again, will try to surprise you. He will not lay back. He may come after your punter once again. Most coaches would back off and return.
A 10-man front. Dion trying to whip up the crowd. Now Sanders is a superb punt returner. He's got a clear path. Tremendous run by Deion Sanders. Inside the 45-yard line. As good a punt return as you'll ever see. 33 yards. Notice how patient he was as he brought the ball back.
The key to this, though, although Deion Sanders does a nice job of running the ball here, was how many defenders the Florida State rushman held up. There was nobody. He had about two or three sacks before any white jersey showed up. He held up the coverage team incredibly well, and he did a lot on his own.
So another great coaching move by Bowden's staff. After blocking one, that time they said, hold him up, and let's let Sanders bring it back and give us field position to go to work again. Now they pound away, and Smith comes free. Great run. Now at the conclusion of this game, we'll select a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team, and Chevrolet will donate a $1,000 scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund of both Miami and Florida State.
Because Florida State has done such a nice job of mixing up their plays, they really, I think, have taken away some of the aggressiveness away from the front of Miami. Those guys are always worrying about the reverse, and now they're just pounding the ball at them.
On second and short, they run the fullback to the 32-yard line for the first down, and Marion Butts is finally hit by Marla and Jimmy Jones, with quarterback Walsh on the telephone talking to the offensive coordinator up in the booth. Even though Miami was terribly impressive against both Florida and Arkansas, Pat, when you look at the number of first, second, and third round draft choices they lost, there really had to be a drop off.
They lost 9 players from last year's team were drafted, 3 of them in the first round.
They banged that draw play with Smith, and he's down.
Well, the other thing is, this is the first week that Miami has played games back-to-back. The first game was against Florida. Then they had a 3-week layoff to get ready for Arkansas. But this was the first time for Steve Walsh to put game plans back-to-back and get ready.
Jimmy Johnson, 3 years at Miami. Some 3 years, huh? He played for a couple of national titles. In trouble here, though. Down 16-3, Seminoles with the ball inside the 35-yard line, and Smith bangs inside the 30. He's short of a first down. It'll leave him with a third down and 4:45 on the clock. Chief Osceola, Board Renegade.
And this is the situation that Florida State has done such a nice job of getting their ball to the tight end, Brent. What a weapon he has been over the middle, and that's Pat Carter.
And we get word from the sideline that Carter injured his leg.
Tom O'Malley is in.
Young man out of Darien, Connecticut, now at tight end. Runs a pattern. And they hit the wide out that time, and Victor Floyd was sliding in behind him to make the reception.
I think there's a penalty there on roughing the passer.
Might have been Stubbs.
McManus takes a big hit after he throws the ball. He held the ball a little bit longer than he ordinarily does. They say Stubbs hit him late. I don't know. I don't think that was roughing the passer call. I think that was a bad call.
College football, you tack that roughing the passer penalty on at the end. McManus over on the side, conferring. Still tied in the seventh. 2 games to go today and tomorrow, and if they stay tied, they'll have a 1-game playoff on Monday.
So personal foul, roughing the passer, gets the defense, be first down.
And that ball is put down at the 12-yard line.
And I thought Stubbs really tried to pull off that.
Smith replaces Floyd in the Seminoles' backfield. Marion Butts, the fullback. O'Malley still the tight end. Lewis and Gaynor are the wideouts. McManus on that bootleg. He throws it this time, almost intercepted. Donald Ellis made a diving attempt to intercept it and couldn't hold on. Benny Blades put the pressure on McManus.
Terrific coverage by Ellis. He does what you have to do inside the 15-yard line, and that's take the inside away from the receiver. Ellis is going to make a nice play. He had taken the inside away from Ronnie Lewis, the flanker, and then shows his athleticism, almost makes a big interception.
Bennett, the fullback. Straight ahead. Battling his way inside the 10-yard line. Taking on three or four Hurricane defenders. Now they come back with Dane Williams at fullback. So against Jimmy Johnson's defense, they are shuttling in two or three fresh players.
I'll tell you what else, who else has played well. That's Mark Salver, the center from Florida State. They have run that fullback up inside here in the second half for big yards, thanks to Salver's blocks.
Carter's injury not serious, and he returns to the Seminole lineup. They are strong to the left. That's the side that Carter occupies. Smith, on a cutback, is hammered in the middle. Benny Blades comes in and hit him as he started to cut back. When you think of defensive backs like Ken Easley, that's the mold that Benny Blades is in. Now watch 36. Smith will cut back, and Blades went after him. This will be a 25-yard field goal attempt by Schmidt, who's had a lot of trouble against this wind. But this time, he hits it. So it's 19-3. And your thoughts go back to a year ago down in Miami. We were in the Orange Bowl. It was the Hurricanes against Florida State. And the Seminoles took a lead. They were ahead of Vinny Testaverde in Miami, 17-14. But then in the third quarter, it was an entirely different story. Testaverde to Irvin. And then he went back the other way to Blades. They scored four more times, 41-23. Miami beating Florida State. But they'll need all of that kind of rally here this afternoon as they trail 19-3 with 2:45 to go in the third.
And Brett, you have to wonder if Jimmy Johnson will look to his freshman, Craig Erickson, the highly regarded freshman from Miami, to play quarterback.
A very impressive performance here by the Seminoles of Florida State. On the short kickoff, fielded at the 18-yard line by Conley. So the unblemished records, Clemson idle at 4-0, Florida State trying to make it 5-0, Oklahoma State and Syracuse battling Missouri. The last time I saw that score, I think they were tied. Nebraska certainly not a surprise, but Wake Forest has been this year. And, of course, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame off to a great start under Lou Holtz. Complete. And Sanders is there defensively.
I'll tell you, that's a good throw, because that's a long throw. Very few college quarterbacks can get the ball near a hash and throw the out pattern to the wide side of the field.
So the 11-yard gain moves the chains here for the Hurricanes. Under pressure, can't get it off. Eric Crone.
Crone that really got a jump on the ball and came right to the outside to give Walsh some trouble. Terrific anticipation by Crone. Now Crone's at the top of the screen. He is number 94. Watch how quickly he gets off when the ball is snapped. He beats the tackle, O'Neal, very quickly to the outside. A deep drop by Walsh, and that allowed him to get to the outside and make the play.
Second and 10. This is Bratton. That's one of their better runs for scrimmage. That's how tough it's been this afternoon with Mayhew getting him out of bounds.
Now, I have been so impressed with the Seminoles defensive secondary themselves coming up and really supporting the run. They bounce things outside. When Bratton's got to the outside, the secondary's been there to make the play.
Seminoles have played with fever down here this afternoon. A little more desire, and that has been the difference. Frequently is, I guess, in an emotional game such as this. In the slot back. Quick pop to Williams coming out of the backfield, and he struggled and battled his way toward what could be a first down with Leroy Butler hanging on.
That was a nice little read there by Walsh, because we had a safety blitz by Shiver. We saw him sack Walsh earlier. That time he read it and dumped it off to Williams.
Henry bringing the play in from the sideline for Miami. So instead of the three wide receivers, they'll go now to two. The Seminoles have used a lot of players here, too, defensively.
Well, that is one of their theories, because a year ago, Brent, they lost three games in the fourth quarter, and they thought because they were tired. This year, they're substituting a lot more players, and they're fresh in the fourth quarter.
So the penalty being marked off.
But offside, defense, it'll be first down.
Well, next Saturday, Dallas, Texas, 2:30 p.m. Eastern time. How good is this Oklahoma team?
I don't think too many people are going to touch them. We'll have to find out in the Orange Bowl.
Bitter rivalry, Texas down and Oklahoma up. See what happens. Williams out of the backfield. He looks the other way, and he hits Henry out of bounds at midfield.
Well, there's a man we haven't heard enough of today, and that's Charles Henry, the tight end. If you're taking Irvin and Blades away, Irvin has got to be open. Big target, too. Good receiver.
Now it's second and four for the Canes, moving down toward the one-minute mark in the third period. Again, goes down the sideline toward him, and he was out of bounds, incomplete.
And he had him wide open.
Third and four.
He was running wide open down the sidelines, Brent. This would have been an easy score. The ball hung in the wind some. No way he's going to stay in bounds. That's an easy score if he throws it inside.
And also, credit the Seminoles with some good tactical maneuvers in that secondary. They just made four substitutions for young Walsh to look at when he comes to the line of scrimmage. They press the wide men. And they've got Bratton against that defense. Bratton breaks free for a Miami touchdown. A 49-yard scoring play from Walsh to Bratton. And now it is the Miami coaching staff that comes up with a big play against that pressing bump-and-run defense.
Well, give Walsh some credit. You just mentioned how they were pressing the wide receivers. And again, what you do is you run Melvin Bratton out of the backfield right up the middle of the defense. It's like a second tight end, except he's coming out of the backfield. He's just no match for the, it's actually a defensive back who was trying to cover him out of the backfield. And I tell you, a big guy can move. He's 220 pounds, but he can get going.
Now let's see what they elect to do with the score at 19-9. Jimmy Johnson will come up and go for two. The quick pass.
Oh.
He's got it in the corner. And Blades takes a blow there at the end. That was a... We'll see that again in the corner and see what happened down there. Blades made a slick catch working against Mayhew. Martin Mayhew was the defensive back.
And terrific touch, too, I want to tell you what. It's just a little fade route. They've run this so many times down in Miami. Hasn't beaten easily. Perfectly thrown right back in the corner of the end zone over the defender's shoulder.
Big moment here for the Hurricanes. Now, following that down in the corner of the end zone, there appeared to be some shoving between Mayhew and Blades. After Blades got back up, it is 19-11 with 57 seconds to go. Let's take a look at this angle following the end of that play. Now, here's Blades. Well, he may have said something, but he gets knocked down by Mayhew, and Blades was going to go back after him. And a teammate alertly stepped in. Let's take a look at this. Now, he catches it. Mayhew, trying to knock it free, cannot. Blades is held up by that fence over there on the outside. Then the words were exchanged, and the blow was delivered. And fortunately, a cooler head prevailed down there. A Miami teammate ran him off. And it's 19-11, 57 seconds to go in the third. Big moment for the Hurricanes.
8-point game, and then a 2-point play is going to have to be made by Miami.
Here is Ross, a couple yards deep. The alley's there. He brings it out to the 29-yard line for the first down.
Let's go back and look at the touchdown. Now, Bratton is kind of come out of the backfield, and you're going to see the double coverage here and here. The three safeties are back. Bratton's going to come right down the middle and catch the nice pass and the touch by Walsh. You see the pressing on the outside, just like you talked about. And then Bratton beats the defensive back inside very easily. Good read by Walsh.
So 76 yards and 6 plays to put Miami right back into the thick of it. Number 3 and number 4. This is Sammy Smith vaulting over a tackler, and then Myra went back out after him and brought him down. So we're live in Tallahassee, Florida. With Pat Hayden and John Dockery, I'm Brent Musburger. Number 3 Miami trailing number 4 Florida State 19-11 here. Sold out Doak Campbell Stadium in Tallahassee, Florida. One of the largest crowds they've had to watch the Seminoles. Both of these teams thinking not just of the championship of Florida, but a national title as well. Florida State with the tougher schedule as you look down the road. They must go into Auburn and over to Gainesville to play their arch rivals, Florida. Smith swinging outside. Gets to the 41-yard line before Blades is there to bring him down.
One of the few times they've run that play to the weak side, Brent. They've been running strong side all day. Nice change of pace.
Sammy Smith with 22 carries for 143 yards here today. And we come down to the end of the third quarter. Florida State 19, Miami 11. College football will return after this message and a word from your local station.
How does the advanced new Chevy Half-Ton stand up to Ford? Chevy gives you more standard power than Ford, more cab room, more shoulder room, more two-sided galvanized steel, new two-tier loading, and a bigger, heavier frame. So how does Ford stand up to the first all-new full-size pickup introduced in this decade?
Not very well.
The heartbeat of America.
Test drive it.
That's today's Chevy truck.
Switzer, I'm going to show you the way football should be played.
Johnson, I'm ready. Give me your best.
Enjoy the thrill of real college football action.
Oh, I thought you came to play football.
With the VCR College Bowl game.
Oh, yeah, you call that your best?
Punt. Go for a field goal. Score the winning touchdown.
That's 2 out of 3.
Well, that just proves you don't have to be a football great to play great football.
Look for VCR College Bowl football wherever games are sold.
Intercepted?
You want to go 3 out of 5?
You bet.
The muffler shop, the transmission shop, the tune-up shop. None of them has this total car specialist, Mr. Goodrich. Whatever's happening with your GM car, he can fix. Because he has more than just a shop, it's like a laboratory. Equipped to diagnose any system in any GM car. And he's trained to understand the total automobile, not just parts. Mr. Goodrich, the total car specialist. No one knows your GM car better. No one.
This is CBS.
The tomatoes look like they just got picked off the vine.
In McDonald's, we're tossing salads fresh all day, every day.
I don't have time to chop, chop, chop.
Every day, I go pick up 4 or 5 salads and 4 or 5 Diet Cokes, and that's our lunch.
Delicious.
I really like it.
Toss fresh all day. McDonald's salads. If we haven't tossed you a great-tasting salad, catch one at half price. Starting Monday for a limited time only at participating McDonald's. Prices may vary. Limit supply.
Tuesday, the 5th.
How's business, pal?
It could be better.
How's that?
This is my car.
So you want an ad.
In the genuine yellow pages.
From CMP Telephone.
Lots of ads, lots of info.
And community facts.
Maps and guides.
So it's bound to get used.
And more people should see my ad.
Pack it up, Pat.
Business is jumping.
And I got myself a new car.
Wow.
Advertise in the CMP Telephone yellow pages. It's everything a directory should be.
Redskin Sideline, Saturday at 7:30 on the one and only Channel 9.
We'll begin the final 15 minutes. Florida State leading Miami by 8 points as the Hurricanes strike with a 40-yard touchdown and a 2-point conversion to pull to within 8. McManus on the pitch to Smith. Smith with a big afternoon here. Gets to the 47-yard line. Let's go downstairs to John Docker. John.
Thank you, Brent. You know, ebb and flow is important in any football game. Well, the momentum has switched over to Miami's side. Between the third and the fourth quarter, interesting that every player on the Miami sideline put up 4 fingers and saluted every other player. They, and I asked them what it meant, they say, we win in the fourth quarter.
Well, we're about to find out as wholesale substitutions being made by the Seminoles. 5 new players on offense. They changed both wide men. One of the running backs, a tight end. And they power Bennett for the first down. Bennett to the 46-yard line with Selwyn Brown bringing him down. And now tempers starting to flare down on the field. This has been a very hard-hitting game.
But inside, the center and the 2 guards, and watch number Tomberlin, number 72, just dominate his man and give Bennett a little crease there. But the inside guys, the center and the 2 guards, played sensationally all day. Lots of creases there.
Now, the officials have let both these teams play, but they might want to think about stepping in here pretty soon. It is first down. Florida State with the wind at their back. McManus to put it up. Intercepted. Intercepted by Danny Stubbs. The big man comes up with the key turnover.
You know, we talked about how strong his hands and upper body is. He fought off that block. He was supposed to get cut. He was supposed to be knocked down. But he made the play. Stubbs is at the bottom of the screen here. Now, Tomberlin, number 17, tries to cut him. But he doesn't get into him enough, and Stubbs make a very athletic play. That's sensational play by Stubbs.
So the senior defensive end from Red Bank, New Jersey, gives the Canes the opportunity they've been waiting for. First down at the 40-yard line now. Walsh drops it to Williams, complete. That play has been there all game, and he's run out of bounds at the 32 with Stan Shiver over there. And Stubbs did it.
It's hard to believe that he is that big and can move that well. Remember, he was a converted linebacker.
Now, Miami with second and short. And the Canes coming back strongly here. Just 2 yards to go for the first down. Here's Williams. He may be short of that first down. As Palmer. Pat, let's take a look here and signal in on the defensive players. McGowan, the ringleader, number 38. He'll set this defense. This is third and short against Walsh. Watch how they react with a goal line alignment. Up over the top goes Bratton. I will never forget Mel Bratton doing that against Boston College and Doug Flutie on that Thanksgiving Day weekend. Bratton scored 4 times in that game, And no one remembers it because of what Flutie did in the last few seconds.
When a back gets over the top, it means the offensive line has done their job, because a back can only do that if no linebackers are there to put the stops on or put their hands up. The offensive line did a nice job there, allowed Bratton to get up and over.
Miami showing great character in coming back in this game. Walsh deflected incomplete.
A late penalty flag went down.
Around the 20-yard line is where that marker fell.
The ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage. No flag.
So he was about to call pass interference, but because the ball was tipped, it is not pass interference. That's what the official saw late.
Lamar Williams, the nose guard, tipped that ball. Now second and 10. And they run the fullback draw with Bratton. Kevin Grant leads the defense. They're all over him. Downstairs again in John Dockery. Doc?
Brent, a couple of things here. The wind has died down somewhat, so it's not that much of a factor for Walsh. What's more important is it is incredibly loud down along the sidelines, and he's having trouble giving signals and getting them to his teammates. That could be a factor down here. Now back to you.
All right, John, thank you. And he faces a big third down. 8 yards to go for the first down. He has to get to the 18-yard line for a first down. They've got Irvin in the slot to Walsh's right. Over the middle to Irvin. He's got it for a touchdown. 26 yards to Irvin, who lined up in the slot and broke free. There is a penalty marker down. But it was thrown back where Walsh went down. And if that was roughing the passer, they'll mark it off on the kickoff.
And I'll tell you, a terrific read by Steve Walsh, a safety blitz. Florida State had been successful with a safety blitz early in the game.
Now you know they'll go for two here in an attempt to tie it, but they are very much back in it regardless of what happens. It is 19-17. So if the two-point conversion fails, and there is a low percentage of successful two-point plays in college football, you still can win this game with a field goal.
They put the ball on the left hash to run some sort of screen play on the right side.
He's all alone. Williams for the two. He broke the plane and got across. And Miami showing tremendous character here in the second half. Bounces back to a 19-all tie.
Two wide receivers on the right side of the screen came inside. Warren Williams out of the backfield. It was completely a mix-up. The linebacker inside needs to cover him. Easy 2 points.
We'll be right back. Score is tied at 19 as Steve Walsh rallies the Hurricanes.
GMAC makes financing or leasing the new GM car or truck of your dreams easy. Just see your General Motors dealer. We'll help your dream come true.
The dreams of America, GMAC. We're making your dreams come true. The dreams of America, GMAC.
Official sponsor of America's dreams.
When the sun goes down, gonna light up the night. Silver label, red ribbon. I'll taste that's right. Gonna light up the night. Low light.
This week on West 57, Lily Tomlin, the actress.
What is reality anyway?
The person. On the season premiere of West 57, tonight.
CBS Sports presents college football. Today's CFA game is sponsored by Michelob Light. When the sun goes down, light up the night with Michelob Light.
GMAC, the official sponsor of America's dreams. And by Ice Blue Aqua Velva, because there's something about an Ice Blue Aqua Velva man.
Miami has scored the last two times it has touched the ball. Six plays, 40 yards in 2 minutes, and Irvin with the touchdown.
The key here is it going to be a safety blitz. This is a nickel blitz here. These are nickel backs. They're going to come up. Well, that happens. The safeties come up, and that allows Irvin, who's right here, to blow right down the middle for the easy score.
Now the penalty after this completion to Irvin, who breaks free down the middle. There was roughing the passer, and the ball will be kicked off from midfield by Bennis. He gets it on the ground to a short man at the 13. And Florida State will have possession at the 26 or 27-yard line. And, of course, tomorrow will be coming your way with the NFL Today at 12:30 Eastern time. We will bring you the latest in the strike update, what's going on at the moment, then the games. And your guess is as good as mine as to what kind of performances we'll have tomorrow. But it'll be unique, and we'll all want to take a look. And the doubleheader game will have Dallas against the Jets in Green Bay, Minnesota. 12:30 Eastern time, we'll get started. First and 10. The ball at the 27-yard line for Florida State. They fake the end around. Smith keeps it and gets to the 30-yard line, where Selwyn Brown was not fooled and tackled him.
Boy, that time the reverse was open. Nobody stayed at home. Had they given the ball to Lewis, he was gone.
I'm sure they noticed that in both boxes upstairs. Second down. Coming up for the Seminoles. We're tied at 19. It was 19-3 at one time. Here it is. And Lewis comes around. Battled his way for a first down. And Tolbert Bain tackles him. But this will be a first down for Florida State. They move the flags. Danny McManus got out and led the way with a block.
You're right, Brent. He's done this three or four times this year. After the handoff, he clears back and peels off and blocks the defensive end. He's done this three or four times this year. There he is right there. There's McMahon, who's going to put the block. Doing anything he can to help his team win.
So he takes Rod Carter out of the way. And on first down, Smith bolts up the middle and almost comes free again with Benny Blades hammering into him.
You know, I didn't think anybody could run the ball this effectively against this Miami defense, Brent. But again, the center and the two guards from Florida State have done a marvelous job of just blowing off the ball and giving their running backs just little seams.
Kuipers and Haynes, the guards. Salva, the center. All are out of Florida. Now 2 yards to go for the first down. Here is Smith again. Swinging outside this time. Comes across midfield for the first down, and the Seminoles on the move again behind sophomore tailback Sammy Smith. Now he'll take a break. He's carried 26 times for 165 yards here this afternoon. And Victor Floyd, number 27, replaces him.
Brent, you've mentioned the substitutions both on offense and defense. And again, Florida State looks a little bit fresher here in the fourth quarter.
Jimmy Johnson pacing that far sideline. This is Floyd getting to the 46-yard line. And that was Bill Huckins, number 54, tackling him there. Most of the tackles being called right now are by linebackers and defensive backs. That front not making the tackles. They're having some difficulty against that Florida State offensive line. Stubbs, of course, a moment ago came up with the key interception, and the Tigers and the Blue Jays continue to battle it out in Detroit. McManus down the sideline, complete, and what a hit there He hit Dossie, and Selwyn Brown tried to jar it loose, but he could not. Dossie hung on for a gain of 24 yards.
When you're a wide receiver running down in the double coverage, you know there's a free safety there somewhere. You're just hoping the ball's going to get there on time. McManus threw this ball early enough that the safety couldn't make the play. And then he did a marvelous job of hanging on to it. Okay, that's a well anticipated by McManus.
Florida State at the Miami 23. We have 8:29 to go. We're tied at 19. Now it is Victor Floyd through to the 19-yard line, and Selwyn Brown bringing him down.
And the sequencing of plays here by Florida State, boom, they pop the ball to the wide receiver, then they run inside, and we saw Smith on the outside as well. This time, inside again. Salva, the center, does a great job of blocking inside on Myra, and again, it's a safety making the play.
They must get to the 13-yard line for a first down. This is Floyd, a fresh back, and he is down at the 19, hit for a loss that time by Randy Shannon, the linebacker. Seconds ticking away here in the fourth. It was 19-3, Florida State. Miami rallied with two touchdowns and two successful two-point conversions. And the big back, Sammy Smith, checks in against Jimmy Johnson.
This is ordinarily a throwing down for most teams, but Florida State has been running draws in this situation all day successfully.
Again, they must get to the 13, 5 yards to go. And they run Smith to the 14-yard line where Jimmy Jones brings him down. And that could leave the Seminoles with about a yard to go here and a tie score. And Bowden did not hesitate. He sent Schmidt right onto the field with the wind at his back. He didn't even think about it.
And interesting, Brent, he said that Schmidt actually likes the ball on the left hash when he kicks field goals. Surprised they didn't run the ball left.
It'll be a 31-yard field goal attempt at 6:28. If you're wondering about why not go on fourth and one, it is a very long one. There's not much question about what you would do here. Kick is no good. Schmidt has missed two field goal attempts and an extra point here this afternoon for Coach Bowden. It stays tied. We've got 6:17 to go. Now it's Miami's turn, and they've scored the last two times they've touched the ball.
Hey, look at this. A free trip after just 20,000 miles.
Yeah, but it would take you 20,000 miles to read those restrictions.
He reads?
Northwest frequent flyers get a free trip at 20,000 miles, period.
They're going to California for the weekend.
It's a frequent flyer thing, 40,000 miles, and they both fly free.
I've got 40,000 miles, we're going to the mall.
Some airlines make you fly nearly 40,000 miles for one free trip. On Northwest, you get two.
Wake up! I could run off the road and you wouldn't know the difference.
I can't stay awake.
Here, revive with Vivarin.
Vivarin
helps wake you up.
Government-appointed experts confirm it's safe, effective.
Revive with Vivarin.
Fancy perfuming aftershave. It's got to be a quarterback's locker.
Real guys who get mud on their uniforms use rugged, honest stuff. Ice Blue Aqua Velva.
There's something about today's Aqua Velva man.
So you still think linemen are dumb?
You're out of here.
One thing's for sure at Meineke.
I'm not going to pay a lot for this muffler, and it better be quality.
Bud says we're not going to pay a lot.
And we appreciate your offer.
I refuse to pay a lot for this muffler.
So don't worry. We install quality Everlast mufflers from just $18.93 installed.
I'm not going to pay a lot for this muffler and still get quality.
You're not going to pay a lot for quality at Meineke.
Had a surprising call on third down.
Well, this is the right hash, and they run the ball to the right side of the field. Now, Bobby Bowden yesterday told us that his kicker likes the ball on the left hash. I am very surprised they didn't run the ball to the middle of the field or to the left side of the hash mark.
Schmidt struggling here this afternoon against Miami, missing a couple of field goal opportunities and an extra point. Tied at 19. 6:17 to go. He may get another opportunity, though. That's the way this game is going. Now, the Hurricanes have scored the last two times they've had possession. Completes to Henry, the tight end, on first down. And he's taken out of bounds at the 29-yard line, close to a first down. Let's check in with Jim Nance in New York, Jim.
Well, Brent, it's been a sluggish day for second-ranked Nebraska. Not even 100 yards rushing in the first half. Quarterback Steve Taylor's been picked off twice, but two Chris Drennan field goals have the Huskers in front by the score of 6-0, 3 minutes before halftime. Let's go back to Tallahassee.
All right, Jim. Well, certainly Nebraska has played a tougher schedule so far than Oklahoma. Maybe they're wearing down. Second and one in this sequence, and Williams, the tailback, has it easily before he's finally forced out around the 37. Matt Patchett leading the way. Now, the last two times Miami handled the ball, they scored in a minute 48 and 2 minutes and 2 seconds, like lightning here this afternoon.
And some of the questions about whether Steve Walsh could bring his team from behind have been answered. No matter how this game turns out, you have to feel better about Steve Walsh if you're a Miami fan.
Now, Oklahoma, we'll check in on them next week. Auburn is still ahead for Florida State. On the first down, Walsh throwing. Going long, wants Blades. He's covered, incomplete. And a penalty marker is thrown. Mayhew covering Blades. The penalty marker is thrown.
I think it was offensive. I really do. I think Blades interfered.
And the way they're bringing everything way back would indicate that's indeed the case.
I tell you, I like Blades actually trying to make the play. You see so many receivers not trying to knock the ball away from the defender.
We have pass interference against the offense. It's loss of down. It'll be second down.
And here it is. Very good position by Mayhew, number 32. He was not fooled all day long. And there, Blades with the left hand grabbed his shoulder and his face mask. It was an easy call there for the official.
This has been a very well-officiated game. Terry Monk, the referee, Tommy Rose, the umpire. So it is second and 25 for the Hurricanes. They run Williams. Gets to the 26-yard line before he's hammered. Now, the two possessions I mentioned to you prior to this, that'll show you exactly what they did. Requiring only 12 plays and climbing back into this game for Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy, who has put together some great defenses, not only his alma mater, Arkansas, but up at Pittsburgh and down at Oklahoma State, where he was the head coach. And now he's hoping his defense can continue to hold and his offense can put together one more march and at least get an attempted field goal. He's coming down toward the 5-minute mark. Got Bratton out. Diving, almost intercepted. Not a wise throw that time by Walsh. He wanted Irvin, who was covered by Dedrick Dodge.
Hey, a quick pressure by Thompson, number 93, forced Walsh out of the pocket. The back picks him up, but Walsh is already flushed. It's a tough throw going to your left. Didn't get enough zip on the ball.
Now, here is a key moment for Bowden's coaching staff. Do they come hard again on Fiegels? Schmidt's having trouble. They've got a 10-man front against him. Sanders set back. They've blocked one for a touchdown already. He gets this one off. Sanders at the 39. He will not break free that time. A 35-yard punt and only a 2-yard return. Bernard Clark, the linebacker, wouldn't let him free. We'll be right back.
Sir, would you prefer hamburger A, a Wendy's hamburger which is always made fresh, or hamburger B, which is pre-made and sits around?
B! It's hard like my Dell toys.
Yes, but wouldn't you rather have the juicy taste of the Wendy's hamburger?
Hey, no pain, no gain. And that B burger, that's pain, yeah, real pain, the kind I like. That burger put some serious hurt in me. I love it. Got any more?
Most people like the taste of fresh hamburgers, like Wendy's, the best burgers in the business.
There's an advanced new shape in heavy haulers, the smooth rounded shape of aerodynamics to cheat the wind and put more power to work. You see it in big rigs and right out front in the advanced new full-size Chevy. With enough fuel-injected Vortec V6 power to tow all these big rigs and this Ford.
The heartbeat of America. That's today's Chevy truck.
The strike is on. The replacements are ready. Where do you turn for the latest? To the NFL today, because nobody covers football better. Tomorrow on CBS Sports.
With Pat Hayden and John Dockery, I'm Brent Musburger. You're watching the game of the week on CBS television. Tied at 19, number 3 Miami and number 4 Florida State. 5:03 remaining. The Seminoles with the ball on their own 41-yard line. Pat Hayden, let's talk about a problem that Bobby Bowden obviously is thinking about right now on the sideline.
Well, it's play selection. He has a kicker that has missed 3 field goals, actually missed 2, but they bobbled 3 snaps. He must be thinking that I have to score a touchdown. I don't want to have my field goal kicker have to win the game.
Smith and Bennett are his running backs. They fake and throw out of it to Bennett on first down. And Bennett puts it on Cruz, and he's run out of bounds inside the 40-yard line. A 21-yard burst. The crowd is upset because of the way Bennett went down on the far sideline. That's why you heard the crowd erupt with some booing back here.
But Brent, a fabulous call, a little misdirection on the handoff, and then McManus rolled around, and then Bennett gets hit late after he comes out of bounds. He's out now. Oh yeah, that is very, very late.
Should have thrown a flag on that. That's the kind of thing you don't want to see get out of hand in a football game. But the ball is down to the 38-yard line. First and 10 now for the Seminoles. They wrap him up, and Smith breaks free. He turned a busted play into a first down, or at least close to it, before Tolbert Bain could finally wrestle him out. What a great talent, Sammy Smith, who is finally doing what Bobby Bowden has expected him to do here for a couple of years.
Watch the block by the center right here, Salva, again, who's had a marvelous day blocking. Again, the draw play and terrific faking by McManus. Everybody thought he had the ball for a moment there, and then Smith does a lot of this by himself. Now, if the wide receiver, number 7, Lewis there, had made a block, that would have been a touchdown.
Now, it was just short of the first down, so this is 2nd and 1 here. And they come with the fullback, Bennett. Edgar Bennett out of Jacksonville, Florida, for the first down. I want to tell you something about this day Sammy Smith has had. We came in here with doubts about this young man. You wondered if he was a quitter, wouldn't play with an injury, if there was a problem involving him. Well, he's carried 28 times for 178 yards. He's made great runs. That was Stubbs who had him cornered on that last run before he pulled away. He has been the workhorse. He is carrying them now. I get that build-up, he'll probably fumble. But it's 1st and 10, and he's played spectacularly well here this afternoon. Comes again. Oh, he is a load. Benny Blades rides him down. Oh, this is the making of a great back.
You know, Bobby Bowden wants to give him the ball 30 times a game, but he did fumble some early in the season. That's one of the reasons they had. Salva, the center, once again makes a dominating block for Sammy Smith. Doubles down on the tackle. Big hole there for Smith. You've got to be impressed with Mark Salva.
Now they have taken Sammy out to give him a rest, and Dexter Carter replaces him, and there might be an equipment problem. You can see him lifting the jersey to adjust one of the... Fumble! The ball is free. Miami recovers. McManus and the center had a mix-up on the snap, and Benny Blades gives the Hurricanes another opportunity at the 3:29 mark. His heart out on that drive, and then the ball is fumbled away as McManus pulled away. He did not have possession.
I think he pulled away early here, or the ball came up short, and then he kicked it. And that's why Benny Blades, the free safety, was able to make the recovery. Well, what a break for this Miami team.
We're tied at 19. We have 3:28 to go in Tallahassee. This is the season of the tie. Williams with a big hole in the middle. I want to watch Benny Blades on this fumble recovery back here in center field. He's the bottom right-hand corner. He's number 36. Now watch how alertly he reacts to the loose ball. Right now, Benny's got it. Wraps it up, just falls on it and smothers it to give the Hurricanes the opportunity. This is a first down. And it is Williams slashing in. Seconds ticking away. I said this was the season of the tie. Last week, we were in Baton Rouge, Ohio State, and LSU. Wound up tied. Yesterday, or on that same afternoon, Tennessee and Auburn also wound up tied.
Again, the wind has picked up here again a little bit. Miami has three timeouts. They've got a long way to go before they're in position to kick a field goal to win the game.
On second and seven, Walsh eludes the pressure. Incomplete, and another dangerous throw on the move. We got a little moment here to break away, and let's check in with the development of Jim Nance. Jim?
Well, Brent, Todd Ellis on a touchdown pass that just put South Carolina in front, but only 42 seconds later, Steve Taylor teams up with Richard Bell. It goes 78 yards, and back in front is Nebraska 13-7, and less than a minute to go before halftime. Back to Brent and Pat.
Yeah, the Cornhuskers show a little character. I'm bouncing back in a big one. In a couple of weeks, they draw Oklahoma State. Couldn't that be interesting in Stillwater? Here it's 19-all, 2:30 to go. Miami with possession and a third down. Irvin's got it. Irvin's free. Irvin's gone. Touchdown, Miami. 73 yards. Comeback here by Jimmy Johnson's football team.
And Brett, that was another audible by Walsh. He has audibled for two touchdown passes this half to Michael Irvin. The defense is set up to take that pass away. With the double zone, that should not happen.
Stunned silence on the Florida State bench, but they still have 2:22 to go. This time they'll set up for the 1 point extra point. They've been successful on 2 two-point conversions, and Cox nails it perfectly, 26-19, and Florida State with 2:22 remaining.
Steve Walsh has grown up a lot today. Again, the double zone, the safety's supposed to take that play away. He didn't get there in time. His angle was bad, and Michael Irvin, it's good night.
Lead it.
300. You know what I did today? I tried to punch out a telephone. Not sure, but he'll give it a try. Silence. More silence. Then I hear a little click. I know it. $1 million. We're a service business. We get paid for our brains. We can't afford a communication system that makes it look like we haven't got any.
Who will be in uniform?
The safety, Dodge, who goes too flat. He's got the deep outside. He goes too flat, and that's why Irvin gets behind him. Remember, it was an audible by Walsh.
And this for Irvin, his seventh career 100-yard game. And folks, he's only a junior. Number 47, Michael Irvin. Now Bennis kicks it off. Fielded at the 10 by Ross. Out of bounds at the 17-yard line. So next Saturday, our game of the week moves on to Dallas, where Oklahoma will be heavily favored over Texas. That's a big rivalry, and if ever the Longhorns are going to respond with a big game, it'll be next Saturday.
And Texas is one of the very few teams that holds a series edge on Oklahoma. Brent, you know, Florida State wasted two timeouts, remember, early in this half. That weighs heavily now because they only have one remaining.
And they trail at 26-19. They were ahead 19-3 late in the third quarter. Now McManus with time down the middle and incomplete. Wanted Lewis. Ronald Lewis, his flanker. Michael Irvin is out of the Fort Lauderdale area. And when you talk about states that produce wide receivers, quarterbacks, running backs, defensive backs, you now must consider Florida to be the most prolific at those particular positions. Just one talented athlete after another. I think of the days of Anthony Carter going up to Michigan and playing up there. Lorenzo White now at Michigan State. They are scattered all around the map. So the second down play for McManus and Florida State. Pressure in the middle. Stepped away. Incomplete. Dropped by Pat Carter. Should have had it.
But I'll tell you, this is Stubbs' kind of game, Brent, now, because he can really come off the corner. But Miami's playing a double zone. That means you got to find a way to get the ball to the tight end or an outside receiver on the inside route. Here is Stubbs again. A tremendous pass rusher. See how strong he is, too. Tips the ball away from the tight end. Carter.
This third and 10 at the 2:07 mark. And they run Smith to the 29-yard line.
Strange call on third and 10 with less than 2 minutes. You've been very successful running the screen pass earlier and getting the ball to your wide out and tight end.
Now they've got fourth down with 1:42.
I can't believe they're
I can't either.
Considering
I was about
going
to
for
say,
it.
I didn't see the punter come on the field, but they're going to go for it. Oh, with a minute and a half. It's fourth and 8. And I think a lot of coaches would have gone for the turnover, but they get it.
Unbelievable.
They make it work. And that was Herb Gainer.
That is a strange decision, but obviously it worked out.
So it's a good one.
I guess so. And that area of the field, though, I can't believe it.
Clock has stopped momentarily as the chains move at the 1:16 mark. Now it's up to McManus and the Seminoles to rally. Carter quickly in for Smith at the tailback position. Now he wants Carter. And Carter stayed inbounds. Now he gets his way out. At the 49-yard line, Tolbert Bain. So Carter knew exactly what he was doing. 12-yard gain. Working with that lone timeout remaining, down to 1:05. And let me tell you something that's interesting about this scenario. If Bobby Bowden scores here, a lot of folks are going to say he's going to go for the two and the win. That's not so. Bobby Bowden will kick that extra point and get out of here with a tie. If that happens, we'll tell you about that story, because he's been burned previously in situations like this. And he said, as far as the national championship is concerned, it won't affect me as much to tie as it will to lose. Now, quick pass by McManus, and Carter had not turned around initially.
You get a guy who will go for it on fourth down, will go for the tie. That's incredible to me.
Fourth and 8, doesn't mean how you gamble on that.
I still can't believe you made that call. Everybody was so casual about it.
A minute 3. Clock stopped here as they get reset. There is Coach Bowden. Now McManus ready. Down the right sideline, wants Carter, who makes a leaping grab inside the 20. What a
catch by Dexter Carter against Benny Blades, as good as there is. A 31-yard gain. The Seminoles ain't dead yet.
Danny McManus has tremendous confidence in Dexter Carter because this ball shouldn't be thrown, really. There's coverage right there, but he gives it plenty of air. He knows Carter is a great leaper. And that is one sensational catch, and give McManus credit for giving his receiver a chance.
Inside of a minute now. McManus going for it all. Touchdown! He got it! He got Lewis! Of Jacksonville, Florida, with a spectacular grab in the corner of the end zone. It's 26-25, and now the story that I told you. You're going to hear some booing here, but this is one thing I want to check. And Derek Schmidt is coming on the field. Now remember, Schmidt has struggled here this afternoon. Now some of the players are over here on the sideline, and McManus and some of the players may be disagreeing with what the coach wants to do.
And this was a frozen rope by McManus. You cannot throw the ball any better than he did on that one. Sensational comeback.
We'll be right back while they talk about this huge decision in Tallahassee.
Down, gonna light up the night. Silver Label Red Ribbon, a taste that's right. Gonna light up the night.
It's the first all-new full-size pickup introduced in this decade. The advanced new Chevy with more cab room than Ford, plus a brand new extended cab.
Rough, tough, working stuff. Feel the heartbeat of America.
Chevrolet.
That's the day Chevy truck.
Take the test drive of the decade in the new full-size Chevy.
The heartbeat of America.
Chevrolet.
That's the day Chevy truck.
McManus has talked Bobby Bowden out of going for one in the tie. The players want to go for the win. McManus was over talking to the coach. It is two tights, apparently. Lewis, the wide man. This a critical decision. And this is a coach who called Johnny Majors this week and said, Johnny, you did the right thing.
I think this is the right call. In my estimation, you always tried to win in college football.
And you know that I disagree. That I say you always try to win a national championship in college football, and that a tie doesn't hurt you nearly as badly as a loss would. And a two-point is so tough to do. But let me tell you something. This man has rolled the dice here the last 2 minutes, and who's to disagree with what's happened in this game? I ain't the coach. I don't have to pay the
fiddle.
He is
on a roll. He
work.
Made it on 4th and 8. And again, I think this is the right call in college football.
You and I will continue to argue that.
Well, I guess Tom Osborne might too.
Yeah, and I do not want to let really an argument interrupt what has become a magnificent football game, regardless of what happens here. I've got to take my hat off, first of all, to Jimmy Johnson of Miami for coming back when they were down 19-3. That was an incredible comeback. Then, moments ago, to put this in perspective, Florida State had that 4th and 8. They didn't even show punt. And now it comes down to this. You'll watch the play, and you'll see what happens. Jimmy Johnson will ice him up a little bit. He wanted to see that formation that they came out in. Jimmy wanted to take a look at the formation. Now he'll huddle up. Bobby Bowden's turn for her make a decision.
If you own a house, you gotta own a shop vac. This baby's got the power to pick up almost anything.
Got broken glass, nails, or wood chips? Shop vac gobbles up stuff that would kill an ordinary vacuum. And a shop vac wet dry can even vacuum water like a flooded basement.
The washing machine is flooding the house.
No.
Every house needs a shop vac. Starting at under $50, a shop vac is heavy duty, not heavy money. And remember, if it doesn't say shop vac, keep shopping.
Of all the furnaces you can buy, only one has Pulse technology. The Lennox Pulse gas furnace. How good is a Pulse? So good, it's backed by a lifetime limited warranty. In fact, it's so reliable, Lennox is making this warranty retroactive to every Pulse ever sold.
Take it from Dave Lennox. For a lifetime of comfort and savings, get a Pulse gas furnace.
Attaboy, Dave. For home heating, you can't beat gas. America's best energy value.
So the drama in Tallahassee has come down to this. The coaching staff earlier this week decided to go for the tie. But the players have said, let's forget about the national championship here. Let's try to win this game right now. Let's win this afternoon. And after all, if this is successful, then Florida State very much on track for a possible national title. Miami has called a timeout after studying the formation. And here they come, the two-point conversion after the touchdown. No good. Miami leads it 26-25 with 42 seconds to go. The gamble fails in Tallahassee.
Say, a funny call there. Pat Carter, the tight end, I thought was open outside in the flat, but McManus tried to throw it up in the air, thinking that Carter could outjump the defenders. But the ball was very much underthrown, never gave Carter a chance. Watch him off the line of scrimmage. He's the tight end. He's out in the flat open quickly. But decide to throw it up for grabs.
Bubba McDowell, who earlier in the game caught Sammy Smith from behind, was back there defensively to bat the ball away. Now, 42 seconds to go. You've got a superb kicking team. Obviously, you can try the onside kick. You are still not finished here this afternoon. You've got the wind at your back. Florida State has had difficulty with the field goal team here. And of course, before you can think about a national title, you've got to win the championship in Florida. Miami already has beaten the Gators, and if they hold on to this one-point lead here this afternoon, they would indeed be the champion of Florida. And then they head for what everyone says is a rather soft schedule until the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame move into the Orange Bowl. But this one is not over. 42 seconds, an onside kick possibility. Some of the players with good hands moving up close here for the Hurricanes. Andrews will kick it off. He has told his special teammates, specialty team, which side he's going to go with it now. And nine Miami players are up near midfield. They move everybody off to his left. He goes in that direction, and Miami falls on it at the 49-yard line. Brian Blades, the wide receiver, right there to fall on the ball. And the Hurricanes are going to win this game 26-25 after trailing 19-3.
What a sensational game by both teams. Still like to call Bobby Bowden. Will get second-guessed all week long, I'm sure.
Well, you don't get second-guessed as much when you go for the two by the fans. And
that's true. You're right.
I think it's more the coaches who say, sure. You know, in the long run, then it looms big to have that tie. I mean, I think that's the group that thinks the other way. Mm-hmm. And it's tough on coaches, you know. And it's tough on these kids to have battled the way they have this afternoon and come up feeling as empty as they do. I don't think Pat, the public, or the media will second-guess him that much. He's very popular with the call. What I find interesting is that they talked him into changing the decision. We discussed that length yesterday because you know how I feel about it.
Yeah, and also it's interesting because he was very set on what he was going to do if the situation arose.
He's been burned on it before.
That's exactly what he said.
Now, meanwhile, Jimmy Johnson, let me tell you something. Everybody remembers he's lost national championships. 3+ years, folks. He's lost only one road game during the regular season. That was up in Michigan. This was a remarkable comeback. Remember it. This was a great performance by Jimmy Johnson's team. Give him a lot of credit. Michael Irvin had a big day. Caught that touchdown pass and one other one. But these guys battled their hearts out here this afternoon. And it's unbelievable to me that for the ninth time in 10 games, Miami's been able to win here. Let's go downstairs now to John Dockery. John?
Thank you, Brent. I'm with Bobby Bowden. A tough decision at the end. What influenced you?
I was going to kick it, and then I said, dang, we've missed about three. We missed three. I couldn't gamble on another miss.
During the week, though, you said you would go for the tie if it came down to that, and you would kick it.
Yeah, I would have, but we missed three in a row. I'm afraid we'll miss four. It's just my fault losing confidence, I guess.
Any regrets at the moment?
Well, I wish I'd have gone for it and made it, but if I'd have gone for it and missed it, I'd have had regrets the other way.
Regrets your call, Coach. Good luck. Thank you. Okay.
All right, John, thank you. And Bobby Bowden, he is a class act all the way. Now, the Chevrolet most valuable players in this game are Michael Irvin of Miami and Sammy Smith of Florida State. Both players with big days. And a check in the amount of $1,000 will be donated by Chevrolet to both schools. Jimmy Johnson is now with John Dockery. So let's go back to Doc.
Jimmy Johnson, incredible comeback. It was like two different games. First half, you were flat. Second half, you were explosive.
Well, I was concerned about our practices all week long. We did not practice well early, and Florida State's got a great football team. They have a great football team. We did not play as well as we're capable of playing, but I tell you what, this team has got so much character. You know, we've been to Norman, Oklahoma, South Bend, Indiana, you name it. You know, we beat Florida on the road, Florida State on the road. It makes no difference where we play. This bunch has got something special inside of them, and they are determined to win.
Jimmy, let me put you on the spot. One, I mean, Bobby Bowden had a tough call to make at the end. What would you have done in his shoes?
Gone for 2 points. We don't play games to tie.
Congratulations on the win, Coach. Good luck to you. Thank you.
All right, John. Thank you very much. So Mel Bratton and the Hurricanes stage a dramatic comeback here in Tallahassee. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations.
The right parts. Mr. Goodwrench has the right parts for your GM car. Parts that fit. Parts engineered.
Featuring the Fighting Gators of the University of Florida.
A long-standing partnership. Again, at the Winter Games of Calgary, the Olympic tradition continues.
Aloha, welcome to Hawaii.
The traditional Hawaiian welcome for the Florida Gators football team. Their first ever visit